Amazon thing. 12 days of deals. Oh man, I'm tired of these fucking Amazon ads. Leave me alone. You wanna buy some more shit? Make sure to use Bob's password. Or his code. We're back. Want to appreciate your name and your band. There you go. Hey guys, how are you? Welcome back. We are about to ride this giant Ferris wheel observation. I guess when they're this big, they call them observation wheels. Somebody puke in there? What happened? Will they just clean it? I think you can see through the floor too. That's kind of cool. Hey, Driller Deep, I appreciate that donation, too. Always appreciate all support, positive comments, and love. And also, of course, donations, obviously, right now, it's my only source of income. So hopefully I can get something else bigger going on so I won't have to worry about having to survive. I feel like such a bum just surviving off of your guys' donations and stuff. But I made the most money this year I've ever made in my life. Like made like about $42,000 this year. I think by the end of the year it'll be like probably about $42,000. I'm at like $40,000 right now, right? $41,000 I think. But it's my most successful year of my life so far of how much money I've made in a year. But I don't know, I need to figure out a way to take my shit to the next level, you know, like a show or something. Like, I have a lot more ideas besides just this live stream stuff. How'd that my brother taste last night? Oh, that guy that sort of looked like me. He wasn't my brother. And I don't know, I didn't kiss him. I didn't go home with him. Me and Stuart and that guy, I can't remember his name. We went to a couple go-go bars. Then that guy left from Australia. He went back to his hotel room. Then Stuart and I went to Nana, and I picked up a girl and brought a girl home from one of the bars. And then Stuart went home to his wife, and that was the end of my night. And then I just went back and boned the shit out of her for like an hour and a half. And it was fun. You provide content, people donate because they want to and they enjoy the content. Well, that's nice. I just want to, like, I need to take my own creativity and stuff to the next level, you know? This live streaming thing's cool and all, but there's more that I want to do. I'd love to have a show on Netflix. That'd be great. I think I do it. Did I eat her out this time? No, I did not. I decided not to do that, probably. Be up here in the sky in a minute. I'm just feeling like shit, dude. All those cigarettes. And then I think the air conditioner blowing on my face the last couple nights, just all that cold air blowing on me when I was sleeping, made my throat sore. And cigarettes, mostly. I already feel like all that guaifenescence helping. Voice acting sounds fun. Yeah, I'd love to do voice acting for sure. Guys, do not come to my chat and dox people. Come on, grow the fuck up, you fucking immature piece of shit. God damn it. Don't post people's phone numbers and addresses and shit. What? Fucking moron. There are after-hours discos that dancers go to after work. Cheap for dates. Whatever, man. I don't know. Oh, where are these after-hours discos? Maybe we should go. I know a little after hours thing. They're up until like 3 or 4. And a lot of girls go there. But it's still like 2,000, 1,500. Burger went to Thailand to give us content. Enjoy. Well, you know, you guys give me so much. You know, I want to go out and do stuff for you. Try to do something interesting for you guys. Hey mods, just keep an eye out if this doxer guy comes back. Can you just be ready to ban him and delete his comments, please? I don't want to dox anybody. I wouldn't want them to dox me in their streams either, you know. And I would appreciate that. We have any mods in here? I know we are in a different time zone now, so. You mean so much. Love. Hey, thanks, Roller Dude Eck. Thank you, Roller Dude K. We got him, Burger. Nice, man. Mod me, Burger. Yeah, don't just mod anybody, you know what I mean? Yeah, time that guy out, too. Just being... Burger's fucking all these hookers for the fans. He isn't doing it for himself. That's right, Robert. I do it for you guys. I'm thinking about each and every one of you when I'm balls deep. Yes. And I will tonight. I'll be thinking the Vagabond. He donated the most tonight. I think Vagabond made my night a lot better. Here. Later. How can you create like the same fucking account over and over again? What the hell? Thank you, Vagabond. Vagabond really showed up in a big way, and I want to thank also whoever, I think it was Tom that said, was he the one that said, hey, let's start a donation train? I got some donations flowing in for a while. That was really cool. And Jackalogical, he's been supporting a lot, and I don't know what you guys do for work, but we really appreciate the generosity. And also Angus has been a pillar in the community, and he's a big donator too. And just good supporter.
Sorry, take it, please.
Huh? Oh, it's in my pocket. Oh, shit. Oh, where is it? There you go.
Thank you, Luma.
Yeah, Rosie. Yeah, we got a lot of good supporters.
If you need any help, you can tell me to see.
Okay.
Thank you.
Let's do this. Oh, I guess I thought you could see through the floor. Donated much once during Danny Brown, but you don't have much. Hey man, it doesn't matter if it's a little or a lot, because $3 is the minimum donation, and that adds up a lot. If I got a $3 donation from every single viewer out of 300 viewers, that's $900, and then that takes away the burden from, you know, like the people that donate a lot. You know, it takes away the burden
from them, you know, like, they don't have to, like, feel like they have to, like, support me so much or whatever. I mean, I just feel like such a scumbag. Hello! I just feel like such a freaking bum, man. I don't know, asking people for money and shit. I'm literally just an e-beggar lately. But,
I mean, people don't have to donate, but... Is this full up?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I can't even put my feet up. We're not even that high up yet. Oh, shit, we're gonna get higher.
You wish Skrill was attached to Streamlabs?
Yeah, I saw Skrill, but I just don't even know what the fuck that is. Is that some Russian currency?
Bluetooth mode.
Yeah, it's like busking. Some give some don't. Yeah, that's true, Oz. Don't touch anything. Sob story, Andy. All my donations end up going towards burgers and fries. Yeah, well, most of my money was going towards burgers and fries, too. But now I'm trying this keto diet, so I don't eat burgers and fries anymore.
Whoa! Are we already going? Are we at the top yet?
I don't know. Not yet. We're almost at the top. Here we go.
Oh, are we going down now?
It's hard to tell. We're, like, at the top right now.
Let's get a view of this market. There's a lot to look at down here with lights.
Man, it sucks the windows are so dirty. It's kind of hard to, like, get a good shot with all this filthy, because it rained today and the windows are all dirty in these pods. Pretty high up here, huh? And this is all fogged up.
There's, I guess that's Bangkok City right there.
Hello! I can give you like $50, but it's in cash. How's that gonna work? I don't know. You have to meet me in person to do that.
Hey, I have had some people when they met up with me, they gave me an IRL donation.
That was pretty cool. Buttercakes gave me $100 when I hung out with her. When I met up with her, and she gave me a full pack of smokes. That was awesome. And then she let me camp out too on her property. She has a little campground. That was cool. Oh, yeah. You're on there for a while now. That's cool. Get my money's worth. Too bad I'm not with a girl, you know? This would be a good place to bring a girl and just kiss and stuff, you know? Get some smoochies. Some smoochy boochies.
Smoochy boochie.
Storm Girl took you out to Disney World and spoiled you. That was a great day. Dude, yeah, and she donated like $100 not too long ago as well. And she took me to Disney. Well, she took me to Disney once and then, what, California Great Adventure another day. Yeah, she's rad. I've had a lot of people look out for me. I guess they saw something in me. They like me for some reason. I entertain them, whatever it is. Maybe I've said something that motivates them or surprisingly somehow. Between all the bullshit I talk about, sometimes I might say something that inspires someone, which even surprises myself. Like, oh, really? I did something that motivated someone, possibly? And she said I was, like, a big motivation for her to start doing her vlogging. I think she started live streaming a little bit, too, but gave her some motivation to start doing some YouTube vlogs and... There were some other people, too. I think Adam the Woo, too.
I think she found out about me through Adam the Woo, or... I forget. Oh, no, she found out about me from Camper Dave, or... what's his name? Camo Dave. Shout-outs to Camo Dave.
Camo Dave.
Watch from hospital bed, really. You will be an actor one day. That'd be great. I'd
but hopefully sooner than later because I'm already 36. I gave you motivation. Oh, God. Jesus Christ. Don't say stuff like this, guys. That's not funny. I'm not into that 12-year-old edgelord bullshit, man. You do it, you're going to get timed out. Okay? You're going to get timed out. Okay? 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 Are you by yourself? This looks depressing. Well, are you by yourself? Okay, then whatever. Then we're all depressed. Great. At least we're together. We have good company. Okay. Had problems with that guy again. Guys, do not type the N-word or call people homophobic words or anything like that. I'm not going to tolerate that. Zero tolerance of hate speech. I'm not dealing with it. If it's hate speech, you're banned. I'm not dealing with it. I'm sick of it. There's already enough freaking hate in this world without people having to bring that shit over to my chat on YouTube when I'm trying to do a freaking comedy show and have fun. Damn it. If you don't like me, or you don't like other people, or you hate everything, then get the fuck out of here. I don't want you here, bud. See the door, buddy. You know? Is that too... Come on. There's too many wars in this world already. And then you got people hating other... You know? Hating whole groups of people because of religion, or the color of their skin, or their sexuality, or whatever. And it's just bullshit. Done with it. Okay. The more you know. Na 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 na. Ba da ba ba da 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 na na. This is a comedy show? If we donate enough for you to get 5 girls, would you? No, I would not, because I need to save money, because I've lost so much money on this trip already. I'm like, my bank account is dwindling to nothing, so I need to make more money, way more money in a day than I spent. This trip was a lot more expensive than I thought it was going to be. Doesn't take that long to go through 5K. On vacation by yourself. You know, if you're with somebody else, you can split the hotel room and stuff like that. A little easier. By yourself, you know. I mean, the hotel room, one of the most expensive things, $35. But, like, the first day I was here, I freaking spent $90 on drinks because I didn't know how much the money was worth and stuff. I didn't really know how much they were charging me for the drinks. I'm like, oh, it's 100 baht. Like, that's $3. That's nothing. Yeah, I'll get all three of these girls' drinks. It's like $10. Okay. But then the price they charged me for the girl drinks was 400 baht. So it's like they were charging me $12 American for each of those girls' drinks. So then it was just freaking expensive as shit, you know, $90. I was buying, you know, I bought Mike some drinks too. I just picked up the tab for the whole table. It was $90. It's good for America, you know, versus how much you'd spend buying that many drinks in America, but... It's like, damn it. That's more than I ever spend at a bar in America. I don't ever spend $90 at the fucking bar. I might spend like 20 or 40 or something. Yeah, I'm on holiday. I'm just a little worried and just kind of voicing out my worries and anxiety of just, I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing with my life next. I don't know if I want to go to L.A., I don't know if I want to go. I need to get back to Indiana and get my van. I don't know if I want to go to New York. It's cold as balls there now. I don't know. I have no idea. But I guess it's only money, right? Money comes and goes. I'll have these memories for the rest of my life. So, and I guess you guys will have the memories of whatever I filmed that you could see through the camera lens. So, you know, it's cool to be. I'm glad the internet works here, that I could share these moments with you guys, and, you know, hopefully we have more fun times than we do.
want to stay in a good mood and have fun.
Become a traveling preacher. I don't believe in stuff like that. My dad's a minister. It's not really my thing. I got a dope place for $500 a month. Dude, you can get a dope place for like $400 a month. Shit, I spent $175 for 5 days at a hotel. I think I got the wrong place. I found it on some website online through one of those like hotel.com deals. And, I thought I was getting a good deal, but hey! Hey, thank you, Destination Storm.
Love you, burger.
Shouts to Camo Dave. She likes for me to give him shout outs. I do. Oh. Yeah, I had a great time with you guys in Disney and stuff. Where are you guys at right now, Storm? When you don't live in California, life's a lot cheaper. I don't know about that. Actually, New York is... I think like going out and stuff is cheaper in New York than L.A. There's definitely less homeless people in freaking New York than L.A. Whoa. Building red thing right there. Man, I love New York, though. I don't know. I have this problem where I lived somewhere for a while. I lived in New York for 8 years. I love New York. But also, I didn't want to just be stuck, be there, and just be thinking, and I've never been out west. So I left New York to go out west, explore it, and just see if it's better. And, you know, I was like, oh, it'd be great to live a year without winter, and legal cannabis is great and stuff like that. And I always wanted to grow cannabis in California, but just never have done it. But I don't know, I don't really want to be just growing cannabis and shit. If I grow cannabis in California, it'd probably just be for like my own personal use, you know. I wouldn't want to do commercial and do it for a job and just do it to have my own stuff. Or, you know, who needs it? I mean, with all the great cannabis there, I'd rather just do something in the entertainment industry.
What the fuck? They got robots over here, bro. Fucking robots. What are... Whoa, whoa.
Oh, they better not be kicking me out. You better not be kicking me out, bro. You better not be kicking me out yet. No. One more time, buddy. No, I don't think so. Oh, no, they're kicking me out. Oh, this motherfuckers. That's all I get for $12. Man, what about these other bitch maids? They go. Oh, fuck. Alright, thank you.
What?
Oh, thank you.
Time's up.
They got spray in case someone farts or something there.
Dude, the investment Paul's getting is mostly going to benefit him. Like, don't you think it's going to mostly benefit him?
You can throw as much money at something. I don't think a streamer house is going to be that awesome. They've already done 2 or 3 scuffed streamer houses. Even if it was like a legit mansion, I don't think... Like, people like watching these people go and interact in public and like IRL stuff. Not sit around at home. You know? Thai countdown 2019. People want to see them go out and interact. Oh no, I think the ferry's done now. Shit. Am I stuck over here now? What happens?
Mike, does anybody know how I can get back? Fuck, how do you get back from here? Let's go see these fucking robots. Let me see if I can take the ferry. I think it stopped at 11, though. Oh, shit, is this it? Nah, it's another one. Let's go see these fucking robot things, then. If we're already over here stuck, let's go see the robots. I don't know how to get back from here, though. Robots. There's robots in this parking lot. Robots. I don't know. There's some kind of, like, motorized robots you ride in or something over here. I don't know what they're... They look cool. I want to see what they're all about. Dude, please, for the love of God, this guy keeps sending me messages. I think I'm going to have to throw the block on him. He's like Mr. G, sending like fucking 8-10 messages a day. It's fucking annoying as shit. People don't even know trying to use me and shit, but then they're trying to act like they're trying to make me something. It's like, hey, why don't you make yourself something, man? Leave me the fuck alone. You're not helping me. You're trying to fucking leech off me. I can't even fucking help them out. I'm not popular or anything. Why they, you know, leave me the fuck alone. I don't need 20 fucking messages. The fuck is this? These are weird battle kings. Whoa. What is this thing? What is this? Hi. You work here? That looks pretty fun. How much to drive this robot? Is it closed or what? Are you open? Oh. What can it do? What can you do with it? What can it do? What can it do? Do the arms move? I just want to see what it does. Can you show me how it works? Can you make it move? Is that all it does? Do the arms move or anything? Or? Okay. Never mind. Whatever. How much is this? $350? Mr. Robot. What can it do? Do the arms move? Does it do anything? Does it just drive around? There's nobody over here, though. Oh, arms move. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to do it. Right on. Thanks. I'm going to pay $12 for that. It's just fucking little motorized wheelchair with fucking robot shit on it. Yeah, that's what I was saying. It's a glorified little rascal scooter. That's what I was saying. Yeah, they just put some lights and, like, fiberglass on it. Exactly. Please do not sit. Why is this sitting here, then? I think you want to sit. Here's one for free. Of course, it doesn't fucking work. It's like a broken one. Bullshit. This thing sucks. I don't want to fucking ride around on that. Taking out the garbage people. Oh, There they go. See you later, band people.
Bye-bye, band people. Bye. Have a nice day.
See you in... Well, I'm not going to be in hell, but Satan will see you there because you're evil. You evil people.
La, la, la. You having a good night?
Yeah,
you too. Thank you.
Oh, they got these Supreme bags. I kind of want a bag to put all this shit in, like my mic and stuff like that. No, they're all fake Supreme bags, but they got a big choice. You can get these way cheaper though. Everything's Supreme knockoff shit. All this knockoff Supreme shit. This shit. Hi, how are you? What are you eating? Is it good? I wouldn't mind if these were just regular backpacks that didn't say Supreme. Like, the only thing, I just don't want to buy it because it says Supreme on it. I'm not some fucking name brand hype beast fucking guy. Hey, there's our boy Snoop. We met Uncle Snoop. I wish it was just a regular little bag. With all the bags they have here say Supreme, man. I don't want a fucking Supreme bag. Then people think I'm a douchebag. I'd rather people know that I buy my shit at Walmart and I'm broke than people think I fucking spend $1,000 on a stupid ass fanny pack that says Supreme. I don't like Supreme. I think it's dumb as shit. All that hype beast shit I think's retarded. What is this dog doing? Is it shitting or... What is it doing? Oh, yeah. It's gonna eat its own shit. Nice. The dog almost ate its own shit. That dog's stupid. People think you're a douche anyway. Might as well get a Supreme bag. Fuck you. Takes one to know one, pal. Alright. Everything's fucking closed out here now. Might as well get out of here, man. We spent too much time sitting and eating. Yeah, I know. There are some you can get, like, other designer ones. Yeah, I wouldn't mind. I don't like Supreme, but yeah, I like kind of like the patterns and stuff. Like that one market we were at the other night. They had, like, fake Gucci and fake, like, Dolce & Gabbana and fake, what do they got, the condensed milk? Yeah. They use that condensed milk for, like, Thai iced tea. What else do I have? Oh, yeah, they had, you know, fake Versace and shit. But, oh, they got fake more shit. That's all of that stupid hypebeast shit, again. Wait, they might have different ones over here. Let's see. Is it all Supreme? Yeah, I don't like Supreme. Fuck Supreme, dude. Ugh. Doesn't even look good. It's like the cheapest garbage. Man, you know what sucks? I think I have to go to the bathroom. Sucks, I just started this stream. I feel like I need to take a number two. I'm starting to get that kind of feeling where I need to find a restroom. I better get to one while I have access to one. Men, women, okay. No, it doesn't suck because I can't afford it. I think it sucks because it just doesn't look good. Look at this creepy little fucking... the eyeball's missing. The lady popped out of nowhere and scared me. Yeah, it just doesn't look good. A Helvetica Bold that says Supreme. There's no design to it. It doesn't even look like good design. It's like they phoned it in. They're not even trying, you know? They just put Supreme on anything. It's fucking dumb. It doesn't look good. Alright, I gotta go to the bathroom. So sorry, hold on. I'm about to mute it, guys. I don't want you to hear the noises of grunting and pain. I think I ate a lot of spicy foods. This is gonna be bad. I'm gonna pause the video. What the fuck? Why is my notification? I thought I had this blocked on notifications. Weird. Did this thing update somehow? Oh god, I hope it didn't update. What up, guys? I'm back. Yeah, I feel better. I had some diarrhea from eating some spicy food. It's kind of working its way out. And, yeah, real spicy shit. It's awful. And, I didn't have any toilet paper, so I had to go track down somebody to find some toilet paper, like a janitor lady. So, finally got that taken care of. My stomach still hurts, though. I feel like there's... You ever have that feeling where you go to the bathroom, but you know that you get out all that you can, but you can feel that there's still, like, something going on down there still. You just gotta wait longer to finish your business. Yeah, that's kind of how I feel right now. Use your hand. Oh, dude, that's disgusting. I'm using my fucking hand. That's fucking gross. Use your hand. Ugh. Am I enjoying Thailand? Yeah, it's been fun. Yeah, it's fun. I mean, it's a little intimidating. I can't speak the language. So half the time I'm talking to people and having to use Google Translate to figure out simple stuff that usually I wouldn't need help with. So that's a little frustrating. I don't know where to go. I don't know. You know, it's a little daunting going to a country, can't speak the language and all by yourself. It's a little weird, but it's so far so good. Definitely enjoy it better when I have somebody that, you know, that's lived here for a while and can show me around. It's a little more fun. Or a little less stress, you know. And it's nice to have somebody that extra person with you is just safer. Usher me. Hey, are there any taxis?
Yes, sir. You want taxi?
Yeah, I want a taxi.
Where are you going,
are you a taxi guy?
Yes.
Do you have a meter?
Where are you going, sir?
I want to go to Nana.
Nana Plaza.
Yeah, Nana Plaza.
It's far from here.
Yeah. You have a meter?
Drink?
Do you have a meter? Yeah, I want to have drinks.
Drink, Nana, you want lady boy, eh?
No, I don't want lady
boy.
No,
I just...
No, I'm going to go to like a bar around there.
Yeah, in the bar, you know, nightclub.
Yeah.
So far from,
well,
okay?
No, I wanted the meter. That's too. That's crazy price. No, too much.
Here.
Too
yeah.
much.
You buy ticket here in the taxi station.
No, I'm not doing that.
Taxi
that's
station.
Too much. No, that's her scam. Snake. You want the lady boy? No. I'm a fucking lady boy. I think I just fucking insulted me too. What a prick. And then 300 baht? You fucking crazy, bro? I'm paying fucking 300 baht. Boom. Guys, don't come here to talk shit to me, please. I already have enough fucking stress in my life about having somebody be a jerk to me in my chat. and my hand smells good. Shouldn't have any shit on my hand. It's good. It's good. The taxi stand is legit though. That's too much. Oh no, it's $10, but that's way too much. Fuck it, dude. I'll walk around and find a taxi. Fuck it. Let's do it. Burger's so salty. I love it. Thank you. What?
No.
I'm a sassy bitch. I'm a sassy lady. Find another taxi. You gotta find a taxi with a meter. Without the meter, they rip you off. Yeah, it's only $9, but whatever. I can get a taxi there for freaking $3. It's three times more than what it should be. I'm not doing it. I'll go over here. This guy's got a meter right here. See? You guys want to get scammed? Go for it. Talk to these guys. Hey.
Hello.
You have a meter?
Yeah. Where are you going?
You have a meter? Nana Plaza.
Nana Plaza. Oh, a little bit too near back.
Huh?
Too near back.
200?
Yeah.
You just use the meter.
Meter 150. You can get.
What? You won't use the meter?
Oh, 150.
150?
Yeah.
All right, I'll do 150. Okay. 150 total, right? Okay. Yeah. All right. That's better. See? That's half price. Okay. Thank you.
Nana Pasa.
Yes. Thank you. You having a good night?
Yeah.
Nice. Good.
Where are you from?
I'm from America.
America.
Yeah. What about you? Where are you from? Where are you from? You from Thailand? Or Bangkok?
Bangkok.
Oh, nice. Staying out that late tonight. I should have left a stream going earlier. Tried to do it off meter so they can take the cut themselves. Oh. Scammers. Some of the best weed is in town. No, it's not. Have I got prostitutes yet? No, just bar girls. What happened with Australia and beer? Bear. Oh, I don't know. He just went home. Oh, yeah. We went to a couple go-go clubs with him and Stuart. And then they were kind of scammer chicks. It was, like, way too expensive. The girl's price was, like, crazy. 3,000 baht and stuff. I was like, get the fuck out of here. And they got, like, oh, let me get a soda. Give me a soda. Girl drink. Give me a soda. You know, 250 baht, whatever. And then they didn't even drink the drinks. Just completely scammed me. And then the girl I like, she said she had a husband. I'm like, what the fuck are you? Why are you a prostitute then? And then the Australian guy went home, and then me and Stuart went over to Nana. And like the after hours club that one of the girls I met the first day took me to. There was just always a ton of girls there. I don't know, it's chill. It's like where all the girls go after work or something. I complain about everything. I thought that's why people watch me. I thought you liked my complaining. God, they scam you for everything. Okay. Well, your boat. You don't like complaining? Here, you don't have to watch the channel anymore. Because you're banned, alright? How did you not know I'm going to ban you for harassing me, dude? God damn, you watch enough. There you go. Yeah, it's like $90. 3,000 baht is $90. Oh no, one girl said her fee was like 6,000 baht. That'd be like $180 American. Crazy. That's like a whole month's rent. Over here. And like, I don't know if you think you got fucking gold between your legs or what, but you ain't worth fucking 200 bucks. Right over here. So, could I have taken them home for 3,000? Yeah, I know, but I don't pay $90 and get a girl for like 1,500, 2,000, 1,000 even. Just gotta negotiate. Gets to the end of the night, they're like, 1,000 is better than nothing, you know? Bot didn't post yet in Discord. It's probably not going to because I was already live before. I was already live before, and then I paused the video and came back, so it's not a new thing. So that's probably why. Paying for their time talking to you. Yeah, you have to like freaking haggle for everything here. Everything is like a haggle. Everything's a negotiable for prices. There's different prices for tourists versus locals and stuff like that. Celibate because I've had sex with over 50 women, probably more than you, Thomas. But I'm sorry if you can get jealous. I know you must be jealous if you try to talk down to me or make me feel bad because you're just trying to bring me down to your level of sorrow. But it's not gonna happen. Women don't count. No. I don't count. I don't fuck any homeless chicks. I bang some tens, that's for sure. No, not 50 prostitutes. I got a lot of girlfriends. I don't hate anyone. Mentally ill women don't count. Hey, I think everybody's mentally ill at some point, in some way. And watch a stream. Who's ready for Christmas? And a half. Watching for a year and a half. Oh, thanks, Brando. Good job. Like the content. Wish you the best. Merry Christmas. One question. Favorite 80s video game. Ooh, thanks, Brandon. Let's get in a good topic. 80s video games. Ooh, I used to love Battletoads. That was a good one. Was that 80s though? I think that was 90s. Battletoads was cool. 80s. What was 80s? I mean, Mario's kind of like cliche. Of course, everybody likes Mario. That one's a classic. And Mario was one of my favorite games, though. I had Nintendo. And I had the Super Nintendo, I think, in the 90s. Yeah, if I, you guys, if anything cool happens or any interesting, funny things, clip it and put it on ICE's Reddit, and I'll take the clips and repost them on my channel later. It helps me out. Your driver's talking loose, that's me. Why not my Subreddit? Well, you could post it on mine, but I think more people would see it on Balls. What's up? How you doing, Sneaker? I was at the Sneaker Chop. What's up, dude? I think I still have that light you gave me. Or, oh, I bought another one like it. I think it finally broke. So, what time is it there? It's 11:54. Hear what Blade did to the girl. Man, I don't care. I don't want to hear about those other people, man. I just want to focus on my life and what I'm doing in my future. I don't want to talk about the other people, man. Sorry. What's the count now? 4. 2 the first day, and then 1 yesterday, and 1 the day before. I try to bring a girl home every day. Every night. Pretty easy. This girl I got was like $45. It's pretty cute, pretty cheap. Guys, I don't want to talk about the Hawaii stream. I don't really care. If I cared, I would have went. I don't want them taking over my mind and my freaking chat and my happiness and my vacation. I don't want to hear about them. So you guys could talk about, I don't care if Bexkadady's talking about shit. Who cares? Whatever. Care. Take that shit elsewhere. They only talking about me because they're jealous. They feel threatened or they feel insufficient that they can. They're jealous in some way of me. Yeah, it's fine. I don't be jealous. Instead of hating on somebody else, they should just focus on what they need to do to make themselves better and what they need to do to take themselves to the next level. Don't you miss your kids? I don't have any kids, buddy. I've got a niece and nephew. A lot of people think I have kids because somebody posted on Reddit a picture of my niece and nephew wearing burger hats that somebody made me and my niece and nephew, and they wanted a picture of us together. And then they said it was my kids on Reddit. So as a joke, one day I was like, can you believe? Like I told everybody in my group, I was like, oh, I'm going to like go like troll the chat and troll everybody. They're like, yeah, go do it. It'll be hilarious. So I was just like, oh man, can you believe my bitch of a wife has been hitting me up, calling me, wanting money. My ex, she's wanting money for these stupid kids. I mean, I just went all in until I was like, I told her to get an abortion. She wouldn't listen to me. I tried to give her an abortion pill. She spit it out. Hell, she stole the cum out of my dick when I was sleeping. It was damn near rape. And I got these damn kids I don't want. I just went like totally like over the top with it. But people really believe that that's how that was true. I just trolled it, I don't know. But it was kind of funny. Your trip is better? Well, it's probably because, you know, my present company is better, you know? And then I don't want to go on the Hawaii trip and hang out with a bunch of people that annoy me. They're all, like, tearing each other apart, talking shit about each other, just doing bad, just shitty, being shitty people, man. And lazy as fuck. Sitting around the hotel the whole time. I guess I'm in a car right now, but I don't know. Just not my idea of fun. If I'm gonna spend some money, I'm gonna go if I would have got a free flight, I would have went. Paul would have paid for my ticket, I would have went. But I mean, this is a free trip. Who's going to turn that down? Even if I did have to hang out with some people I don't care for. If I'm going to spend my money, like, fuck it, I'm going to Thailand. That's where I want to go. I'm living out my dreams. I've wanted to go to Thailand since I was in high school. So I was like 18. Now I'm about 36. That's about 18. Let's see, 28 there. That was almost 20 years ago. 18 years ago. For like the last 18 years, I've been wanting to go to, you know, 18, 20, you know, I don't know, 15 years I've been wanting to go to Thailand. So I've been wanting to go here. Could have made closer to 5K. Wherever, man. Never change my money. I don't want to sit around and leech off with ice beside you, man. I don't know. I just feel bad. I'm not like just putting the camera on Paul and making money and shit like some of those other guys. I mean, I've done that before a handful of times, but you know, usually when I hang out with him, I don't even stream anymore. I just go over there without my stream because I want him to know that I'm there to be his friend. I'm not there to like use him, or I'm not there to just like exploit him to make donations and stuff. Yeah, any idiot can make money, a bunch of money, pointing the camera at Paul because he's so popular right now. But you know, I don't know. I actually considered him a friend and stuff, so consider him a friend. I'm not, I don't know. This friendship means more to me than money and stuff. I already gave Ice's channel back. So, whatever. I didn't hook up with any lady boys. You guys just seem real jealous because I'm in Thailand right now, and you probably want to do something else with your lives if you're upset and hating on stuff, and you know, you're jealous that I'm out doing stuff and you can't figure out a way to make it happen for yourself. But you can just go out and figure some way out, save some money up. Hey, if you have to move into your van for a while like I did to save some money, nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that. Move into your van if you need to, save some money, and then you can go travel the United States, travel wherever. You know, that's what I did first. I traveled the United States last year, the last 2 years, and then I don't know, this year I've been traveling abroad. So went to Iceland with Paul in London. It was nice that I was able to stay with him in his hotel a few nights to save some money. I stayed in Iceland at a hostel. When we were in London, I got a hotel with Tracksuit Andy one night when we were in Farnborough. I think we got 2 nights at that hotel, or one, and then I stayed in Paul's hotel on a pull-out couch with Keenan, and that was nice because I saved a lot of money instead of having to rent a hotel. It was fun in London. I went out with some people. Some people came and stream sniped and hung out. I just checked the ban list in 60s and said there's 5,392 people banned. I don't think that's true, but I doubt that's true. I just unbanned everybody like a week or so ago. I don't think I've hit the button 5,000 times, but who knows? I wonder how many people he has banned, though. How many people does he have in his ban list? Yes, only 5,000? We must ban more. Remember when 16 you said this is the best year of your life? It has been. Do you regret the way you acted these last couple weeks? No, I don't. I don't, because, I don't know, I'm just stubborn, and, I don't know, I believe, and whatever. I've always been stubborn my whole life. That's been a strength and a weakness. Remember your Adam22 podcast? You were at the top of the world, boyga. Yeah, that was pretty cool. Well, hopefully, I mean, I've done stuff for MTV, I've done a lot of cool stuff in my life. I mean, Snoop Dogg, Shepard Fairey, actually got to interview him, like a legit interview. I don't know, a lot of people that I mostly try to find people to interview that I, like, admire. Probably one of my favorite people I've interviewed is Reggie Watts. Or some other people I've met. Who are the people you guys have seen me meet on stream? I met a bunch of people just like that one week. Oh, Danny Trejo did that little skit with Danny. Did I find Stuart annoying? No, I like Stuart. He was cool. Let's go to Hawaii. What? No, I'm not going to Hawaii. Hawaii streams are better. Well, go watch Hawaii stream. Why are you watching me? Fuck shit stack. Yeah, that's Reggie Watts. Is it close? It's coming up?
Yeah.
Where?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I got a 10 in my pocket. I just gotta find it. I got more. Is that 10?
Thank you.
I don't know if that's enough. Where's it at?
Yeah,
Where do I go?
No.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
God bless.
Or Buddha, whatever.
I don't know what to say over here. I don't think they say that. What up, dudes? I've been with 11 in 4 days. Two the first day I was here. Have I only been here 3 nights? What the fuck? Has it only been 3 days? I don't know, I've been with one more girl than the days I've been here, so I guess yeah, today would be day 5 or day 4, and that would make 5. Yeah, so I don't bang lady boys, but even if I did, would that be an issue? Grow up. Hey, mate, can I bum a smoke, mate? Could I bum a smoke? Could I have a cigarette, please?
From 7-Eleven, but you can have one.
Could I have one? Is it okay?
7-Eleven?
Yeah. Oh, cool. Thanks, sir. Where are you from?
From India.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
There is a store, 7-Eleven.
Okay, you can buy I'll buy a cigarette. Oh, okay, I can buy cigarettes. Nice. Thank you. Apparently, they sell cigarettes at stores. Did you guys know that? It's more fun smoking other people's cigarettes. You know that. I don't want to buy a whole pack of cigarettes because then I chain smoke and I'm fucking sick. I just wanted one. Scary. Fuck. So crazy, there's so many nice, you know, hotels and stuff, and then there's just, well, I guess every city has, like, poorer parts and stuff. I mean, there's some of the shacks in Thailand look better than some of the stuff that people are sleeping in L.A. People are sleeping in fucking tents. They don't even have a shack. At least they have something kind of permanent. They don't have to move their fucking shack around and stuff here. I don't know. There's all walks of life in every city. I've been to a lot of cities in America, and I've been to London and Farnborough and Reykjavik and now Bangkok. But mostly been to cities in the US. Is this Nana? Nana's up here? Okay, thank you. Is that Nana up here? Okay, thank you. Why I've always wanted to go there? Because I've always loved Asian women. I don't know, just something about them. I figured, what's the best place to meet Asian women? It'd been in Asia. So. I've had a lot of Asian girlfriends. I dated girls from India, which is also technically Asia. Wow, look at this guy. I've dated girls of every ethnicity. I'm definitely not. I don't really care what color of skin someone has. I'm more attracted to like their personality and what they just beauty. Their beauty, you know. I find beauty in every. You know, I don't care about the color of skin. You know, I mean, I definitely care about like what their face looks like and stuff like that. But I've had a couple girlfriends that had a lot of acne. And but their bodies were a 10, but their face was like a 3. I mean, they had a pretty face, but then there were a lot of, oh man, they're not gonna want me filming out here. All right. Let's go walk around. A lot of these girls don't want to be filmed out here though. They sell panties and bras and stuff. There's just like lots of girls. Where there's just like tons of girls. Or they got like salted fish. Fish. Oh, what are you doing? That's cool. Nice. Cool. Guy's in deep concentration. Well, that's probably good. He's gonna cut his hand. Looks like he's done that a few times. Ooh, they got little Are these snails? Got little clams, prawns. They got Viagra. Make you hard. There's a bar right there. It's crazy out here. Burger's so sad. I don't know, man. I'll wake. I go to sleep with a smile on my face every night. This band sounds good. Is it midnight? You can't film after midnight. Ah, it's midnight. You can't film in the clubs after midnight because they have bar girls and stuff. Smell the AIDS. Hey, don't be rude. Hi. One bottle of water? Water? How much? 10. He's got his own little grill. I need that. See, these are five. These are 5 baht each. They don't have pennies, but these are basically pennies. Or they're actually nickels, kind of nickels. This is what their 20s look like. So we got 80. All right, we're good. I spent $300 the first day I was here. Just spent way too much money. I gotta save back some money. I gotta pay taxes in April. Gotta make sure I got enough money. Have a nice night. Cup coon cup. Alright, bye. Oh, blue crab. I
ice cold water for 10 baht.
Yeah, that's funny. Doesn't really rhyme as much as a dollar.
Ice cold water for a dollar.
Oh, sorry. We're out here. They got a Hooters. There's two Hooters on this one street. How many ladyboys have I sucked up? Who can keep track? So many. Millions. Oh, God, I get so much congestion, it sucks. Gotta get that cough syrup. It's helping out. Hey, how are you? Yeah, there's one station like called Nana Plaza. I guess there's a bunch of ladyboy bars, but there's like bars here with like regular girls. I guess this area is known to have like more ladyboys or something though, but there's also a ton of hot chicks here too. I like this little bar. It kind of reminds me of like a little New York bar. Can you film in there? Are you guys the... Hey, can you... How are you guys the door guys? Or...
No.
Oh, okay. Oh, I probably can't bring this water in.
We can, you know what?
Oh, it is? Okay, thank you. Hey, is it alright for me to film myself in here? Is it okay? Is it okay for me to film myself on my... Is it okay for me to do a video of myself? Of me?
Oh, you want to sit in on... Okay. Yes, can.
I was gonna sit at the bar. Is it bar? Okay. I need a freaking whiskey. Let's do it, boys.
Let's do it.
I'll have a Jack Daniels on the rocks.
Jack Daniels on the rocks?
On the rocks, yeah. Thank you.
$20.
Actually, it was like $20.
burning sickness. Am I going to get naked tonight when I get back home? How much is that drink? I think it's like probably 160 baht. Hey, 150 baht. Okay.
That's not bad.
A baht, 100 baht's like $3. So, it's like 450 for a whiskey. Jack Daniels is more expensive here. It's an import.
Cheap.
Cheap. Cheap, cheap, cheap.
Cheap, not expensive.
Cheap. Good price. Wanna say hi?
What's that?
Where you come from?
I'm from Hollywood. Oh, just so big, so crazy, you know? It's like, I make videos, like, comedy videos, and I go around and sing and stuff.
You want a lady crazy,
right? You're gonna sing? I can turn it on.
Hello, you want a lady crazy, you come in Thailand, please, come on.
Nice. I want two of whatever she's having.
Where you come from?
Huh? I'm from California, right? I live in California. What? What?
Oh. This place yourself.
What?
When you want to take video on.
I make money doing my video. People give me money. Yeah.
50-50, okay, man.
50-50. Alright. Alright, put it there. No! Oh no! No!
No!
Oh man.
I think you want.
It's all fine. It's all good.
What's your name, Kenneth?
My name's Joshua. Josh.
Josh.
Yeah, Josh.
Okay, Josh. My name's Ming.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Cheers.
Yes.
Are you going to RTR? I don't think so. I wasn't very welcome there, and there was just a lot of drama with the people. They didn't like me doing my live stream, even though I asked everybody that I interviewed if it was okay if I put them on camera. I mean, walking around, you see people behind me. You know, I mean, you can't ask freaking everybody or walking around, but if I was going to, like, talk to somebody, I always ask them if they want to be on it or not. Or if I could, like, check out their rig or whatever. Yeah, it just wasn't very welcome there at all. They try to make it seem like everyone's welcome kind of thing, but it's really not like that at all from my experiences. They definitely discriminate against people there, which, yeah, they're hypocritical. Is Pattaya next? RTR is your best content? RTR was cool. I think the Trump protest is some of my best content maybe of this year. What do you guys think was the best content of this year? We had a lot of good streams this year. What are some of your favorite streams, favorite burger moments? Let's reminisce. How many ladyboys have I effed? None. How many of you effed? It's my best and only content. That's not true at all. You obviously don't watch the show. Women posting on their message board, they were scared of him, had nothing to do with it. Yeah, I don't know what that was all about, why they're scared of me. Like, I don't know. It's like some witch hunt bullshit. I didn't bother anybody. Well, there's a lot of really old people there, and there's people there that are like on the run or have warrants from and stuff, or like women that are like trying to hide from their deranged psycho husbands and stuff. Like, I don't know. It's a big mess of people out there. I don't know, but yet, like, the YouTube vloggers over there get treated like royalty, but since I live stream, everybody treated me like shit. And then all the vloggers started live streaming after they find out how much money I was making, how good I was doing it. And they're like, oh, maybe I should start live streaming. Should I go to RTR tonight, Randy? I don't know. Am I gonna shut the F up? Well, this is my channel. I talk on it. If you don't like hearing me talk, maybe you should go watch someone else. It's a pretty easy decision. If you don't like something, don't watch it, you know? It's your, at this point, it's your fault for watching something you don't like. How's it mine? No one might have said that you said you boned her. Oh, yeah, I didn't ever said I boned her. I said that she was really pretty, and I was like, maybe she's the one. Maybe we can travel together. I don't know. I never said we hooked up, though. I don't know where she got that. Like, find the clip of me saying that, and then I'll, you know, and I'll believe it, but I don't remember saying that. I don't just make up stories that I hooked up with somebody or whatever. So, I don't know. Whatever. And the rotten apples. Hey, I'm just gonna ignore them. They'll give up sooner or later. I'm not gonna give them any attention. $3 Texas speech, $5 media. Yeah. Timmy Kimmel. Nice. Amnesia in it. Nothing better as Burger talking like an angel being in my ears. Never heard that before. You would have 380 burgers if you didn't have a burger. You would have 380? Oh, wow. I have 380. You mean I wouldn't have, or what? I'm fine with 380. Did I meet Cheap RV Living? Bob? I saw him at his thing, but he doesn't like people really talking to him that much. He acts like he's some kind of god over there or something. Acts like he's a celebrity. I don't know. The guy's kind of... He's kind of a strange guy, I don't know.
Damn, damn.
Rise above the plebs. That's right, Jake. Thank you. I love you, buddy. Burger, you have more skill on your pinky than all of CX, by the way. Hey, thank you. I feel like some days I don't, but it's nice for you to say that. I like Bert and Ernie haircut. Oh, thanks, dude. Thank you. This is something I put together here for the ladies. We had over 1,200 viewers. People are boycotting and watching your stream back here on the Bone Plain CX News. Yeah, well, whatever. They're lost. They can go watch the sleep stream or whatever. You know, I don't care. Whenever I got banned from the Reddit and whatever before, I went off and did my own thing and still had 100 to 200 viewers a night. So, you know, whatever. I'm happy. 100 viewers is great. That's amazing. I got almost 400 now. That's awesome. Even way better. Go back to RTR2K viewers, show them up. I don't care, man. I don't know. I just don't think that's the crowd for me. A lot of those people are just, they're really, first of all, I thought there was going to be like some younger people there. There's very few people in my age group. I mean, I'm not even that young. I'm 36. Everybody there is like retired, stuff like that mostly. Like really old people. I don't know. There's kind of strange, some of the people were kind of strange, you know? You live in a van and you get kind of introverted. Some of the people, they're a little out there, I'll say. Weird bunch. Strange, strange bunch. Why did I change six? Inspire? I've already went over this. I changed it because, because Doink said he had the password and he was going to, like, delete the videos or something, but I guess he was trolling or whatever. Take Ice to RTR. I'm not taking Ice anywhere, dude. Anywhere I've taken him, you know, he just kind of embarrasses me, and that's saying a lot because I embarrass myself quite a bit. But, you know, when I went to the, I don't know. He doesn't ever want to hang out with me anyway. I think he doesn't like hanging out with me much anymore. Whatever. I'm going to do my thing. I don't do my thing, move on with my life. I think I'm thinking about going to New York soon. I wanted to go to New York this spring. I've been talking about going to New York. I wanted to go to New York last spring. Then I traveled across the country, and I didn't make it there by spring. It got too long. It's not about quantity, it's about quality. Who's having a drink right now? Cheers. Burger is more Rooster Teeth than CX. What does Rooster Teeth mean? Talk guys about starting East Coast Network. Maybe I will. I don't know, it's a good idea. They said maybe if you were more receptive to ISIS invasion. chances, you would have better luck. Never heard of rooster teeth? I have, but I don't really know what it means. I don't get it. Your ego put you in that situation. All right, man, whatever. It sounds like you just regurgitate everybody else, like, oh, delusional, ego planet, blah, blah, blah. I mean, do you have any original thoughts, or are you just a parrot that pipes out everybody else, what everybody else says? You know, there's leaders and there's followers, you know? I don't know. You can decide where you are and which one you are, but there's people and there's sheeple. I don't know. Personally, I've been a sheep before, but you know, I'm just trying to march to the beat of my own drum right now and live my life and have a good time.
Hi, how are you? You having a good night?
No.
I'm on YouTube.
We have like about 400 viewers right now.
I used to live in Hollywood, California. Now I don't really know where I live. But, yeah. You have a good night?
You too.
Thank you for saying hi.
I like this place. It reminds me of kind of like old English pub or like New York pub. It's got a cool little, it's like a little kind of like cozy little, kind of little skinny little bar.
Yeah.
It's a nice pub. This one's not so much about the girls, it's more about just getting a drink. Yeah. Like some of the bars are just like, you know, tons of girls or whatever.
I think they're pretty funny. Nice. I mean,
yeah. Yeah, they got good personalities. No, 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 yeah, yeah, yeah. Ah. Yeah. Get some, yes. It's a retirement pub. Hey, I'm 36. Might as well get used to it. I'll be there. Time to retire. Wants you to drink more. Yeah, the more I drink, the more I buy. That's how it works. Hey, what were some of your guys' favorite streams from this past year? You don't have the money to retire. That's true. I do not. I can know it.
Jack,
rocks. CX News, that's all. What? You watching City Chelsea now at the pump?
Is this City Chelsea? That's Chelsea.
Manchester City, yeah. I don't know, that's what's on the tube, on the telly. I don't know, that's just what they got on. I'm not watching it. I don't care about sports. These are great streams. Thanks, two plus something. I can't see the rest. Samuel, just stay in Thailand stream. Get away from CX. Eventually, you'll get viewers. We're just being in Thailand. Look at CJ Wright and Jake and me. Yeah, that's true, man. I mean, do your own hustle and stuff. I've gained a lot of viewers and people, too. Even whenever ICE banished me last time from Discord, I still had Discord and the Reddit. I wasn't really in the Discord at all, so that didn't matter. But the Reddit kind of hurt me. That's before he had CX Network. And I still got 100 viewers. Definitely got more when I would trend on Reddit and stuff. Yeah, I was getting like 600 and stuff. But yeah, CX Network is growing, and that's great. Yeah, that's good for everybody that's on it. Good for Paul, too. You'd rather watch me than DJ pretend to be drunk? Okay. That's cool. Yeah, I don't know. What am I doing for Christmas? I'm not sure yet. I'll probably be here doing something. The gathering of the Juggalos. That was fun. I wish I would have done the Juggalo paint, but I didn't have access to a shower or water or anything. It was like, I'm going to wash the paint off. So I didn't do it. It was like, oh, I don't want to have the paint all over my beard. How am I gonna wash it off?
I told you, you said you know, okay.
But you just like the humor. I mean, what's good for the goose is good for the gander, kind of thing, you know? Like, I'm not like a big fan of like their content and whatever, them as people, but you know, like any success for everyone helps me out, helps Paul out and stuff, so that's good. We're talking about team, yes. I miss you selling art in the corner with music for Rachel's dreams. Yeah, those were cool. It's just me making art. It all blurs together. It's been a long year. Go to Twitch. Why? I'm not going to go start over and go to Twitch. Hell no. Everybody. Will I ever go back to You Now? No. I made no money on You Now. And the dreams on a square and the resolution's garbage. And you only make like 35% of your donations. So no, I'll definitely never go back to You Now.
Yeah, I kind of trust that you.
Hawaii looks lit. I'm not in Hawaii, I'm in Thailand. Go get a burger boy. Go get a burger boy. Go. Nah, just ate earlier. I had cashew chicken, and I had tom yum, chicken tom yum soup. I should have got tom kha. I like the tom kha, but I like it. You ever try hitting up MTV again? No, I haven't. I do know. I do still have some contacts at MTV though. Again, maybe I should contact them. Bert, are you working on any new shirt designs? No, I haven't. I need to. That would be fun too, just to do some drawings. I had intentions to make drawings, but I don't know. I just end up sitting around watching TV or doing something else, you know, instead of doing something productive a lot of times. Which I think we can all be guilty of, but you know, I hate that. I really need to be more productive. The night at the gay bar is fun. Yeah, it was fun. Yeah, what up, Saddlebutt? How you doing? Love your stream. How's Hawaii? I'm not in Hawaii. I'm in Thailand. Need to cop some more burger merch. Hey, yeah. Date yellow shirt girl. Can we make shirt designs and send them to you? I mean, you can, but I don't know. I want to design my own shirts. Burger, you and Bumpkins have a great chemistry. Hope you guys do more together. I'm not sure. I liked doing CX News, but I don't know. After seeing how the community got and all the hate and stuff people got came to me, and how all the people treated me afterwards, I don't know. I'm not sure if I want to do it again. I don't know. Right now, it's leaving a bad taste in my mouth, per se. Had a lot of passion for it. Didn't really seem like now a lot of people in the Reddit community are just backlashing and showing me all this hate. It's like, why do I want to do a show for people that hate me? You know? I don't know. I'm not sure. Probably not at this point. I don't think I'll be doing it, but maybe. I'm thinking about it. I need to do some thinking about it. Soul surgery. I'm not feeling so good about it right now. Oh, so you're the victim? Well, I'm not saying I'm the victim. But I don't really care for how everybody treated me in the community and stuff. So I don't get upset right at school. That's true, Tony. Thanks for putting me in perspective with that. I'm going to pick my negative thing that people say. Well, it's easier said than done, Corey. I think Adam 22 is still in Japan. Hell yeah, dude. Oh wow, thanks Rocky Gamer. I wear glasses too, hey. You having a good night? Do you read English? Tell her hi, guys. I don't know. I think I'm gonna move on. I really want to move on and do my own project. Because I'm just kind of thinking about it. I'm like, you know, this whole live streaming and everything, all that thing. The most views we have like 14k or something. Or right, the most views we got on the video was like 45k when I did the fake black eye after Paul got beat up by Hampton Brandon. That was our most viewed video. And I don't know. I don't see the potential for that channel to like grow bigger than Ice Poseidon's channel, or to grow, you know, it's very niche, you know, only people that care about Ice Poseidon or CX or whatever are probably going to watch it. I mean, there's probably some new people that might be introduced to it, but mostly it's just people from this community. It's kind of very niche. I'd like to have something that just anybody can enjoy. It's not so specific, and it's not about scumbag people that I don't like, you know? I was extremely biased on CX News, because I really don't care for most of those people, honestly. New Evan, yes, I'm Evan 2.0. Why not just reenact live stream films? Live stream. I'm gonna be doing more edited things. I want to do more edited stuff. I think I'm gonna get away from some of the live streaming and stuff. Go more to edited comedy stuff. Try to do like a Churdly or some kind of something like that. You know, that like Gus Johnson or something like. More comedy videos. And I actually want to like create a show that's just mine and all my ideas. I don't have to make. I can make it about anything I want, whatever topic I want, whatever thing. You know, it doesn't have to be about CX Network or one thing or another. I can just do what I want to do with it. You know, and not have anybody. Have anybody to answer to about it. I'm moving backwards, live is moving. Hey, whatever, that's what you guys think, but you know, whatever. Still, I mean, Casey Neistat's killing it, he doesn't go live. I don't know, there's a lot of people doing well that don't go live. A lot better than me. You know, Mr. Beast. Yeah, I don't know. Back to 100 viewers for you. Well, you know, I might figure out something else to do besides live streaming. I have some other talents. I make paintings. I make videos. I play the drums. You know, maybe I'll move on and do something else in my life. I don't see myself live streaming for the rest of my life, that's for sure. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll move, do something else, you know, a new chapter. I don't know. I've been doing this 3.5 years. I still like live streaming, but I like talking to you guys, but when I live stream it, I disconnect from everyone else in the real world, and it's, you know, I'm connecting with you guys, and I'm not connecting with everybody else as much sometimes. I'm not focusing on the world around me as much, I'm focused on just the phone and looking at myself, and, you know, it's just like, I miss a lot of opportunities to talk to people and connect with people when I go out and stuff sometimes, you know, because they don't want to be on the live stream and stuff. So, I don't know. It has its positive and negatives. Walmart pays $15 an hour. Oh, do they? Where at? Maybe in California, not in the rest of the country.
last 4 years or so, I've never spent it.
Suck it up, Burger. Play the role. Quit letting ego get in the way. It's not ego. It's just wanting to move on to the next level for me. You know, I can only grow so far. You know, I think with this live streaming thing, I think I need to focus on, like, you know, instead of spending my days walking around and filming homeless people and crackheads and getting drunk and stuff. I need to focus on myself and what's important to me. Do some writing, write a pilot for a show, and get produce the show and try to pitch it to some networks and get the show picked up and move on to, like, another level besides just doing live streaming. You know? That's what I want to do. It's been fun. It's been a fun party, but, you know, I need to, like, expand. I still want to do live streaming. I still go live, but maybe not, like, all day. Maybe not every day. Maybe, like, once or twice a week. Have a schedule. I'll go live, probably. You know? Get a job at a gas station. Well, I have a lot more talents and better things on my resume than getting a job at a gas station. My dad wanted me to get a job at a gas station. Ice made me? I mean, I was on MTV when he was still, like, in junior high school. But, yeah, I guess... Okay, I mean, he definitely helped my stream career a lot, and I was live streaming and doing IRL before he was, but he definitely helped me get a lot more viewers, that's for sure. But he didn't inspire me to start live streaming like all these other CX leeches all, like, started leeching because they saw how successful he was. They're like, I want to be a live streamer too. I did it because I like doing it, and I did it, like, another friend of mine, he was, like, successful. His name is Mr. Cashier on You Now. He was doing pretty well. So that's why I started doing it in, like, 2015. And my first stream was IRL. So I didn't jump on the bandwagon and, like, start streaming because of him. Honestly, I didn't know anything about him. I just was like, oh, this guy's getting a lot of viewers. I should meet him. That's about the extent of it. I didn't have any idea how toxic his community was or racist. If I did, I probably would have thought twice about it. Blah blah blah. Yeah, I want to get on TV or Netflix or something for sure. I have too much talent just to be walking around going to bars and fucking doing stuff. I got a lot of ideas up here. You got to see a little taste of it with just, like, shit that I didn't even plan that much, just improv stuff I just threw together with CX News, and people seem to enjoy it a lot. I need to do more stuff that's, like, even more planned out or whatever. Have I tried selling your soul to Satan? Every day, he just won't buy. You got a lot of talent, by the way. Thank you. You already have tons of material on your streams. Best of Burger subjects. Delusional. Well, maybe you think it's delusional, but maybe that's just because you live in such a small bubble of your own life that Mr. Cashier made you. Go to NYC in the spring. You're funny, Curtis. You'll make a show. I predict Danny Brown will collab with you in the future. He already said he wants to. Yeah, Burger was always on the boulevard late night, for sure. But I think Ice to bring you the investor money. I mean, I don't know. I don't really care, honestly, if he does or don't. It's not going to affect me, probably. I mean, it'd be good for him. It'd be great, but I mean, it's not really as much of my concern. Burger Musk. Yes. With a minimal amount of acting experience. I've taken a lot of acting classes, done an
improv, to do stand-up comedy, to do radio, stuff on MTV, hosting a show, hosted my own show, been in a few just like little independent things, independent shorts with friends and stuff. I've done stuff, you know. I don't need somebody discrediting me, some keyboard warrior discrediting me and trying to bring me down. I've done a lot of things in my life, and I'm proud of my accomplishments, and I'm proud of what I've done, and proud of the hard work I've done. And I've made a lot of paintings, I've done a lot of cool stuff, been in a lot of bands in college, playing music, and art. I don't know, I've just been in a lot of different scenes. I've always been like this. I get obsessed with something for like 2 or 3 years, 4 years, and then I just kind of like want to do something else and change gears. Well, what's nice with live streaming is that can allow me, I can still live stream myself making paintings or playing the drums or doing whatever. I just film myself doing it. So that, I think that's cool because I can like switch gears and do different stuff, but yet still live stream. It's kind of cool. How do you stay positive? Well, sometimes it's easier than others, I'll say that. It's definitely easier whenever you're on the love train and not on the hate cycle. Very you're funny and could be on TV, but you need to focus on it. That's what I'm saying. Maybe I need to live stream less and focus on like taking my career to the next level. You know, stop partying so much with all these people and party and stuff. You know, if they want to live stream for the next 5, 10 years, whatever, that's fine, but maybe I need to like focus on like what I need to do. I'm like almost on 40, and I need to like take my life to the next level. I have some ideas. The only thing that's holding me back is myself. You know, that's the only thing holding me back, myself. My own ambition, how much effort I put into things. Oh, it's not too late. Like Steve Carell wasn't even in any movies or anything until he was like 37, 38. I mean, there's a lot of actors that started their career in their late 30s. Actually, tons of actors. Look at Rodney Dangerfield. He started doing stand-up comedy in his like 50s or something. So then he was, you know, he was huge. It's never too late. Only people that say it's too late are people that already gave up. And you know, you can give up, but you know, that just because you gave up once doesn't mean you can't go back to your dream. You know, you live a long time in life and you have a lot of time to do stuff, and there's no reason why you can't do what you want to do in your life. All you have to do is just do it. That's the secret. You know, you just got to find a way, sacrifice, and make it happen. You want to be an artist, just make art. You know, you might not sell anything or whatever, I mean, but just have a passion for it, do it, you know, and then eventually, you know, usually takes about 10 years to master something or to be successful at it, so, you know, or they call it 10,000 hours, usually takes like 10,000 hours of working, so some people can get the 10,000, if they more you put into it, you get the 10,000 hours sooner, but there's a lot. Yeah, I've given up on stuff and on dreams, but, you know, the thing is, come back to it. You know, I want to come back to it. You know? Can you see your matches on Tinder? Fake news? You don't believe in 10,000 hours? Well, whatever, man. Kevin Hart lost the Oscar over tweets. What? I love what you're saying, brother. It's motivating me. Yeah, I mean, I've given up on a lot of stuff in my life, but the thing is, I've also went back to a lot of stuff, too, and tried doing it. I don't want to talk to ladyboys for content. I don't like exploiting people, and I don't think it's funny talking to someone just because they're, you know, ladyboy or trans or something. I'm not 12, so fuck you. Why don't you go talk to a, you know, someone with an alternative lifestyle, yourself, get out of your own fucking, you know, I don't even think it's funny, I don't know, I'm not, like, enabling people to think that's funny, like, oh yeah, lady boys, let's make fun of them and stuff, no, that's not what I'm about. This guy's spamming the same shit. I'm gonna make it real easy for him. Oh wow, Dan, I banned you, you were being nice. Oh, well, this guy's being rude anyway. Whatever. Why don't I talk?
like Patricia? I don't know. I never got her number. I met her one night, bought her a milkshake, and then flirted with her, so I thought it was, like, kind of funny. I was drunk, but... Well, I won't be reading any of the ones. On a serious note, Burger, you need to better manage your YouTube channel and upload real videos so you can gain your own haters. You know what? You cool, Burger. Hey, thanks, Manny. Cheers to you, buddy. There should be a guy named Manny that was from UNO. You exploit people on a daily basis. What the fuck do you mean? How do I exploit people? Everybody's exploiting themselves. What are you talking about? You go to work every day for minimum wage or whatever. You don't think you're exploiting yourself? I mean, you don't think... All right, whatever. I'm not going to get into it, but... You weren't drunk when I met Patricia. I was trash. It was like 6 in the morning. I've been chugging whiskey all night. Are you kidding? I had an argument with my brother. Your streams really help. Thanks. Okay, Roderick. Hopefully you and your brother work it out. Yeah, they're playing Freebird. I can hear it. Hey. Whatever, man. Helping them out. They're helping me out. I don't see the difference between giving a girl money here or taking a girl out to eat, buying them drinks, taking them out places and stuff. You're going to spend $100, whatever. People use and exploit each other for sex all the time. There's no difference. You're bragging about eating out tired. I'm just saying, you know, how many people out there are married and they don't even, you know, the woman doesn't work or anything. You don't think she's not exploiting you? And then some men don't want their wives to work, so they have to rely on them, so they don't have anything else. They don't have any other options. They're so insecure that the woman will leave them or have some other, you know, go with someone else or whatever if they have other options. I don't know, man. Different strokes for different folks. This is a different culture. How can you hate on it? It's not America. There's different thoughts, you know. You gotta get outside the little box that you're thinking of in your little town, your little city, your little whatever, you know. There's like a whole world. People do things different ways in different places. And it's not all the same everywhere. You know? Take some Thai shrooms. No, I don't want to take any shrooms. 3 days in town, you've got no interest in comedy. Well, quit watching then, Tim. I'm tired of hearing you bitch about it. Go cry a river. It's a free show, bitch. Hey, man. There's a lot of people married out there that are unhappy and they're not getting any sex. So, and your wife's still spending most of your money. So, tell me who's getting cucked. You want the sex, you're not even getting it. Or you've been fucking her so long you don't want to fuck her anymore because you're tired of it. Let's be honest. You've been fucking the same pussy for a while, you get tired of it. They get tired of your dick too. You know, people want to experiment with other stuff. That's just the fact of it. That's why a lot of marriages end in divorce. You've been fucking somebody for 5-10 years or whatever, like, this shit's getting fucking boring. You know, start arguing, shit like that, you know? It's just, why do you think most people get divorced? I don't know. Just saying. Don't judge me. Anybody judging me is just jealous, I think. Jealous that I'm getting some pussy and having fun and you're sitting at home watching. I mean, otherwise you wouldn't watch. Well, I have kids. I don't want any kids.
How much?
Mama long, 145.
What?
Late.
red, white, and green.
Red, white, green?
What's, 145.
What's white? Lights or something?
Yeah, I show you.
I'll just take the green, the menthols. Do you have purple? You don't have purple?
No, green the metal.
Do you have any purples? The purple, the grape?
No. Only green and the metal. Oh. What do you think?
Okay, the metal? Nah, I'll probably just go to the 7-Eleven.
7-Eleven.
Yeah. No worries. I don't have two kids. That's my niece and nephew. Yeah, the grapes are the best. Here, I'm gonna get just pay for this and get a drink somewhere else. I might come back.
You
want to
go buy for you?
Huh?
Someone can go buy for you.
No, I can go buy.
Okay.
You just want me to stay here drinking the whole time. Ah, I know you.
You don't need too much, just 2 drinks, so.
Yeah. That's all I need. I'm crazy now. Ah!
I love mine. I love mine.
Well, I'll pick up some smokes and I'll give you one. If you want. I think it's about the only bar I can film in. Can I get around Thailand with 1K? I mean, if you can, yeah, I mean, you could probably, like, how long are you going to be here, a week? I don't know. I've heard some people say, like, oh, you can, like, live in Thailand off 1K. It depends on, like, what kind of lifestyle you live over here, you know? Like, you know, you're bringing a girl home overnight and shit. That's going to be, like, you know, $60, $75 a night, shit like that. Hotel, so I mean, you're spending $100 a day and stuff. So, I mean, yeah, you could stay like maybe fucking 10 days or something. $20, I think. I mean, you can probably get cheaper ones or something too. I don't know. You can negotiate. What's a good tip? 20? Is 20 okay?
40.
40 is a 1,000? Is that better?
No, 40.
The late one, okay.
40? What's wrong with 20? It's no good?
That
I'm a cheap fuck.
Don't ask,
she's
okay or not. Don't ask.
Yeah, cheap fuck.
Okay. If you want to keep, you keep. Don't ask, it's okay. Thank you, John.
What can I say? I'm a scumbag.
Yeah, I hope you come back. But I let you know. I'm gonna keep the team, don't say. I give you 70, it's okay. I say, I can tell you.
Not okay. 40.
Because you had a question.
I know.
Don't have
I'll be a back. Question. You want anything from the store?
It's okay.
You good?
You can leave it.
I'm not leaving my phone here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. You can leave it. Yeah, right. I'll leave it. Excuse me. Sorry. 7-Eleven. She was from Venus. She had a detachable penis. Oh, this was fucking... Whoa, I thought I recognized you for a minute.
Okay.
Where are you from?
Germany.
Oh. You look like this guy Kyle, my friend Kyle.
No, I'm not Kyle. I'm Yannick.
I thought you were Kyle for a minute, but yeah, I noticed you're not Kyle now. Have a good night. Am I leaving CX Network? No, I'm not leaving CX Network. I'm just kind of thinking about the future, you know, like the next, what I can do in the next year or two, you know. I need to like figure out how to take my own brand to another level, you know. I don't see why there's any reason why I can't take my shit to the next level. Because I had a lot of people enjoyed CX News, a lot of good feedback, and that was inspiring me to like, you know, man, I need to do some more shows, man. You know, come up with some new concepts and whatnot.
Yeah.
Oh, just
do you turn up?
Hello?
Bing, bang, bong.
What different flavors do you have in Marlboro?
I think they have berry and Arctic. Like,
really? I've had the grape. It's pretty good. Grape's good. The purple.
I'm a fan of the lights.
You like the lights?
I call it berry.
They have one that's purple.
Is that on berry? This one.
Is that purple?
Yeah, it's purple. It's like the berry.
There's a taste of mint or something.
The other one is Arctic. They have Marlboro Arctic.
Okay.
And that's just like really menthol.
That's like menthol. This one is berry.
Okay. I thought it was a grape or something.
You want to try it? I can give you one if you want to try it.
Sure. I think I've already had it. Is it the purple? It's purple, right?
It's purple.
Yeah, I bought that. I've had those before. They're good, though. I like it. That's what I usually get. Oh, shit. We're not in line.
Knock.
I was like, wow, everybody keeps getting in front of me. I guess I'm not in line here. Don't you hate having to clean your glasses and stuff? It's just like, so many times.
Oh, you
a little smudge.
Shower or something.
Yeah, I'm about to do the ping pong show.
Oh, alright.
No, I'm kidding. I'm just out interviewing people. So I was living in California, but now I'm about to go somewhere else and travel a little bit, and then maybe go to California, maybe go to New York. I don't know. It's a little cold to go to New York right now. I don't like really being in the winter, cold winter months, but I don't know. LA's nice in the winter. Cool story, bro. I'm trying to connect with a fellow glasses wearer, okay? Don't hate me, guys. I wonder if they have other fruit flavored.
Can I have a bowl of lights? And then the lights.
What other cigarettes do you have that are like fruit flavored? With fruit. I know you have the purple, right? Is that the only one? Do you have camel purple or camel fruit? Does it have fruit? Does that have fruit too? Or? That one's fruit too? I guess we'll go with the Marlboro. Yeah, I've already tried those. Yeah, I'll get the Marlboro. I've already tried these. A pack of fucking cigarettes again. Damn it, I'm so fucking weak.
And it's 65
hours. Damn it. Hate myself. 165. There's 160. Is that? Thanks. Time's just relevant, right? Oh, God.
Fat.
Like a little baby with a low birth weight. And this one's showing how your penis is going to be erectile dysfunction, I think. Great. Wonderful. Cigarettes are so rad. I wish I never fucking ever smoking this shit. Fuck. Stopped smoking and started smoking. Ugh. Fucking worst shit ever. I wonder how much money I've wasted on this shit. Still going to smoke, by the way. My throat fucking hurts, I don't know. Okay. What's up, girl? How you doing? Why didn't you say you want to go in there? Like, oh no, you are so weird. She's like waving at the camera. And I put her on the camera, and then she's like, oh no. So weird, man. So do you want to be on it or not? I don't care. If you don't want to be on it, I won't put you on it. Most of the time, that's why I just film myself. And like over here, I don't want to bug people and shit. Like, some people get mad being on the camera because they might be cheating on their girlfriend or their wife or something. They don't want somebody to accidentally see them on the internet or something. They're like, oh, there's Jerry. He's cheating on his wife. Hey, you got a motorcycle? Nice. How you doing? I'm doing a video on YouTube. Just walking around. You want a cigarette? What? You want the microphone? Oh, okay. What do you want to say? Oh, I got lint in my lighter. What the fuck is it? What? Do I what? No, no thank you.
Why not?
Not my type. You're not my type. I'm sorry. No, I don't think so. But have a good night. And she said 100 baht. That's like $3. Hi, how are you? I'm good. Oh, sorry. What does your tattoo mean on the back? What does your tattoo mean? Is that like Buddhism?
You're lucky.
You're lucky? Did it work? Or do you feel lucky? Is it working? Are you getting more luck?
No.
No? Fuck. Only bad luck. Oh, no. And they do like all these. It's almost like my body is rejecting this poison. Weird. I'm not exploiting people. I'm just walking around filming people. I'm just filming what's. I'm just showing you the world, showing you what I'm seeing, showing you my what I'm experiencing. That's what I do. I'm not exploiting anyone. I just simple question what her tattoo meant. I mean, it wasn't mean or rude to her. She's not mad. Hi, how are you? I like these guys. He got like a whole cart of food next to the scooter. He's got his own like buffet right here. It's crazy, dude. He like built this thing himself, like welded it and shit probably, or some dude made it. That's fucking awesome. Throat cancer from eating hooker pussy. Oh god, me and Michael Douglas are both fucked. I'm gonna go back to the other bar. I can at least smoke in there and I can talk to you guys. This is a cool bar though, we just walked past. I've been here like the last 3 or 4 nights. It's cool. Or the last 3 nights I've been here. I keep coming back, so it's like legit. Ping pong show. Everybody got a goddamn ping pong show. How did so many girls shoot ping pong balls at their pussy? What the fuck? I'm back. Hey, I'm back, old chap.
Okay, welcome back.
I'm back.
Is that a sex?
I got some smokes. You want a couple? Yep. Did you miss me?
Me you so much.
Here you go, man. Cheers. Every one I give you is like one at two. I don't have to smoke. Here's one for now, one for later. You want one too?
Yeah.
Anybody else want?
No, only me. And everybody good lady, not me. I'm bad lady. So what you like to eat?
Another
Let's see. What other whiskeys? Yeah. Is how much is Jim Beam? Same?
Jim Beam.
Is it same price? Is it same price? He's actually got like this little flavor thing that makes it taste like berries. Is it menthol? You don't like it? I'll smoke the other one if you don't want it. Alright, sorry mate. I didn't know they're kind of minty or whatever.
Jim Beam 150.
Oh, it's the same price. Yeah, let me get a Jim Beam on the rocks double. A double.
Double.
Yeah. Thank you. Man, I got fucking lost, dude. This place must cater a lot to English, just not like soccer. Yeah, or football.
Yeah.
On the rocks, just like my life. Boy, that joke gets more and more real every time I have a drink. Finally, I got that fucking shit. Ow, my teeth. I got a little gap between two of my molars. Right.
You like more ice?
That's good. Thank you. I got a little gap between my molars, and then it's a food trap. Food gets trapped between it. It sucks. The guy who I had orthodontics with, he fucked up my teeth. He didn't do a very good job. So there's like a gap between my teeth back there. Don't do it on stream. Alright, whatever. I flossed. Okay, I don't know. That's so gross. I don't know. I carry dental floss because every time I eat, I get food in between my teeth in that one spot. And it bugs the shit out of me. And you get bacteria and stuff growing that can give you gingivitis or gum disease or something. So I try to clean it out.
Is that free from you?
Maybe that in your room, man. Whatever, man. I don't give a fuck. Am I ever going to see these people again? Like, oh no, this guy flosses in public. It's not like clipping your fingernails or toenails or something. Floss your ass? Oh yeah, get the towel in between your balls and your ass. Oh, yeah. Looks like a little mini crevassier glass. Cheers.
$50
Before 50
and
now it's rough. It's mellowing out. Look at this ice cube mouth.
What is that? What are you guys mostly up to? Is that a thing?
She did that? She did that? Is that like an Asian thing or something?
No,
like,
I don't think so.
Wait, let's see. What is it? How do you do it? What is that? What does it mean? It just looks like you're drunk. Oh, wait. Oh, you're drinking a big ass beer. You get a drink while you work?
Yes, this one.
Nice.
Yes,
cheers. Is that the cum face? I don't know what the face is. I don't know what it's supposed to mean. I don't know. It's a thing they do.
Yeah.
Hey, that'd be cool if you're going to bartender and drink while you're working. That's cool. Ugh. No hate. Some Grand Marnier. Ooh. 8-inch clip. That's one of my jokes. Nice. Somebody's been watching the streams. Just got an 8-inch clip, bro. I like a lady boy with an 8-inch clit.
That's funny.
It's code for likes anal.
The more you know.
Mace someone to raise your sock. I haven't seen them sell any pepper spray. They sell tasers though. Open your own bar? Nah, I don't want to open my door. What about opening up a food truck? Maybe at one point in my life. Personally, I make some money. Afford to have capital to do something like that. Once you make a certain amount of money, your money works for you. Once you have enough money, you can invest it in other things. If you're smart about it and it works out, then your money works for you. Then you make more money, and then it starts compounding. You gotta get a certain amount first to be able to do something like that. Or get a loan or whatever. It's obviously better if you don't have to take out a loan. If you take out a loan, then you're gonna be paying back the money plus double, three times the amount or whatever on a loan. That's how loans work. I guess it'd be better to take out a loan than it would be to give equity of your company in the long run. Says the guy living in his van. Says the guy living in a 4-star hotel in a third world country. Hello. Success.
So this year, for 1 year, I pay $40,000 each month.
4-star hotel for $35 a night. $35 a night American, not bad. You can find places for $20 though, $20 a night.
So the discount is $480.
Show the girls. Here we go.
$480,000.
Show the girls. Show the girls.
$400.
Show the ladies. Hey, sexy lady. Whoop, 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 whoop. Whoop a Gangnam style.
Because I said
I feel like Bill Murray in Lost in Translation. He was in Japan, but I love Bill Murray, man. That's somebody I'd love to meet. I'd love to meet Stevie Wonder too. I bought Bitcoin at 20,000. I'm set for life. At 20,000, dude, you're broke, dude. You bought it. You bought it when it was at its very highest. You idiots. You buy it low, sell high. You buy Bitcoin now, it's low. Not when it's at 20K. I don't think Bitcoin ever got to 20,000, did it? You did it wrong. Oh, is your gooch showing? Can you see something? Can you guys see anything? Bitcoin's been steady crashing. I heard it's supposed to come back though.
No more.
4-star hotel and a 0-star bar. Hey, I'm a star, and my mom says I'm her number one son. She had me first.
No girlfriend.
I seen an 8-inch clip. I seen a 8-inch clip. It would be I saw an 8-inch clip. Proper grammar, please, Scottish King. How are you, sir? Welcome back. Burger scared all the customers away. Yep. I really know how to shut down a bar. This place is going out of business. I think Bitcoin's going to 100K. I don't know about that, bro. Bill Burger. You like Bill Burr? Bill Burr's pretty funny. My favorite comedians are Jim Gaffigan, Demetri Martin, Mitch Hedberg, Rodney Dangerfield, great one-liners. Always liked, who else? Oh, CK, I like some of his stuff. He can make you laugh sometimes. Sucks that he, like, his career's kind of fucked. Is he going to come back? I don't know. Burger Coin, best investment ever. Hey, what up, Galactic? How you doing, buddy? Sam Kinison. Oh, I remember Sam Kinison always had his big overcoat on.
We need 7 shots.
I know that. You want a napkin? Well, I said you might get spit in that, dude. Kyle Kinane. Dude, I met Kyle Kinane. I met him I've seen him do comedy a lot in New York when I lived in New York at Upright Citizens Brigade. And I met him randomly at a deli. He was really nice. He had like his hoodie up and stuff, but yeah, I recognized him. I was like, "You Kyle Kinane?" He's like, "Yeah, man, what's up, man? How you doing there? How you doing? Hey, man, how you doing, dude? It was nice. I met a bunch of celebrities in LA off camera too. I met John Hamm, I met Bob Odenkirk, like a bunch. I met Bob Odenkirk probably 6 times. Talked to him a bunch. Not too much. I only really had talked. I saw him quite a bit. I didn't want to bother him, but I talked to him probably about a handful of times. Who else? I saw Johnny Knoxville. I got a picture with Forrest Whitaker. Most of the guys I didn't get pictures with because I just felt like such a douche getting a picture with them. I was like, it's kind of annoying. I like when people get pictures with me, but I feel like maybe it bothers them. But I guess looking back, I haven't seen John Hamm again, so I should have. Like, John Hamm was pretty cool. I was like, John, what's up? I was like, John. He was like, back. We connected. You're a corrupted girl's ass. It all comes out when you're famous. Nope, never. On and on. Straight. Oh, here comes the mic.
Bluetooth mode.
Underneath the boulevard shadows. Searching through the night. Street lights, people learning just to shine in motion.
Sorry, I let you know now. If you want to take me somewhere, cannot to do it.
I can't do it now anymore?
Somewhere cannot.
So what?
If you want to learn, you can ask my boss.
I can do where?
You can ask me first what you can do.
What? I don't understand.
If you want to laugh, you want to voice.
Oh yeah, I won't sing. I can turn it off.
Yeah, but
I don't want to bother people.
I'll let you know somewhere you cannot take video. You know?
Oh okay. Is it okay to take
cannot
video?
Cannot take video. Cannot take the photo. I told you somewhere cannot.
Other.
And here, you can do, but cannot. Do
yeah, the other bars you can't. Yeah, I know.
Somewhere can.
That's
somewhere.
Why I'm in here.
Long time, maybe.
Yeah, because of the bar girls.
It's a man, cannot long, but you might just.
I know. Thank you, though, I know.
What is the world coming to?
I wouldn't say that I'm normal. I'm pretty abnormal. I like to nourish my inner weirdo.
Something you can do.
It's not you that's the weirdo. It's the fact that you're recording it all.
The what?
Oh. The fact that you're broadcasting.
Well, I make money doing this. People donate. That's how I make my money. It's my livelihood.
I don't get it.
Well, people donate when I do funny stuff.
I'm saying I don't get it.
Well, I'm basically a cam girl, but I don't do sex stuff. It's more comedy.
If you were naked and you were doing a dance set, I kind of get it because there's so many weirdos out there, but you're sitting in the bar having a chat.
You know what? That's a good idea.
Huh? What's my YouTube account? Oh, okay. Okay. You want to check it out?
Mona, there's no stopping you.
Can you down on you?
Mona giving it away.
No
bar fine for Mona tonight.
No bar fine for Mona.
No bar fine for Mona.
Oh, T-Rex, nice. Like the music here. That's all shit I know. Hey, Triller D, please don't use words like that, please. I'm gonna delete your comment this time, but next time I'll have to time you out, man. But thanks for the donation, I just can't have... You know, people saying stuff like that, please. I don't like that word. It's derogatory. See, now I have cigarettes. It's fucking over. I'm sick as fuck. It wasn't Gordon Ramsay's, his friend.
Yes, you're my girl. Girl, I'm just a genius for your love.
Somebody like you.
Somebody like you.
Ban those cigarettes, bud. Yeah, no shit, Tim. Good call.
Talk to my little friend.
Reminds me of Scarface.
Say hello to my little friend.
Wait, Drunk in Love by Beyonce? Normie? Oh my god. This is T-Rex, dude. This is way better. I listen to T-Rex any day over Beyonce, but hey, to each their own. Tell them you're the famous Josh McCutcheon from YouTube. You're Andy Milo, Milo and Jason. Burger, this storm shall pass. You will rise from the ashes, my prodigal son. I'm streaming. Like a phoenix from the ashes, I shall rise. Yes, yeah, not the first time I've been on the Reddit hate cycle. How many times have I been on the Reddit hate cycle, guys? In the last year and a half? Quite a few. How many do you think it's been? So Time for another drink. Oh man, I'm still working on this one, boys. Delusions, well, all of life's an illusion, bud. I love this one. It's like they can't show a dick on it, but they like show how it's all like bent. It's like my wiener won't work. That one's funny. This one's supposed to be impotence. They couldn't show a penis, so they're like fingers. They hear. This won't work. Impotence. I'm laughing about it. Taiwan looks like a ton of fun. I gotta go someday. Yeah, man, it's fucking, it's like a whole new world over here, man. I've never been here. It's, I'm glad I finally came over here. Any alcohol that's not flavored is keto. Scotch, whiskey, vodka, gin, rum, that's all keto. As long as it doesn't have flavor in it. The flavoring's where you get the sugars and stuff. No beers, no wine. You can drink skinny girl wine, actually. Man, my nose is like, it's the cigarettes, man. They're fucking making me fucking congested as fuck. Enjoy your vacation from your vacation. Yeah, right. Make sure to talk to Mummies. He's a true friend. Don't burn bridges. Yeah, I'm not trying to burn bridges, but I might not come back to LA. He knows I've been wanting to go to New York. I've been talking about it for like 2 years. He'd be like, fuck, keto, get some authentic chicken pad thai. It's not worth it, man. I'm losing weight. I'm not fucking chain smoking. What is that? Yeah. True that, dude. Michelob used to make low carb beer. They still do. It's called Michelob Ultra. They still got more carbs than are good for keto, though. People hate on Burger because he goes against the grain, yet still remains a 4D chess master. Thank you, Galactic. New York is cold. Yeah, I know. I lived there for 8 years. Thank you. Will the van make it to New York? We'll find out, won't we? New York sucks. Homeless in the winter? No thanks. Hey. New York's fucking awesome, actually. Burger, are you from Scottish? Looks like we're going to be in New York for New Year's, boys. We're going to be watching the ball drop. Not my hood, blood. Yo, what up, blood? What's up, blood? Yo, what up, blood? We're going to rent a place in New York. I don't know. I needed to save some money for my taxes. Maybe I'll go back and live with my mom until April or something. Maybe I'll move with my brother.
Oh, that's a good strong ambiance.
What about Sam Kinison? Yeah, he's okay. I'm not. Sam Kinison kind of was like Lenny Bruce.
We used to hit the ball and the necklace would just go, fuck, man. Medicine ball or a football?
Last place you gain weight is the first place you lose. Yeah, look how much thinner my neck looks. It looks thinner. It does. I've lost weight, guys. I'm already losing weight. You can tell. You can see it in like less than 2 weeks. How long have I been keto now? 10 days? 2 weeks, maybe? Maybe 2 weeks on keto? I've been on keto about 2 weeks now, right? It's my fourth day in Thailand, so yeah, it's been probably 2 weeks. I've been sticking to it, too. Yeah, my face is getting slimmer on my cheeks. It's like not so round. I notice. I don't have as much fat here. I can feel it. I can see it.
How much the bar find in this one?
What?
Oh, you're watching it now? Here, you can do the chat. Here. Here's the chat. Here's the chat. They're watching your stream. Hi, bartenders. Oh, shit. Wrong turn. They're watching you guys. Whose phone is this?
Hey! Oh, should have been your first time. But you haven't got any left foot. You're a Premier League player.
That is type of pussy. It tastes like every good pussy, man. I don't know.
I mean, that's a perfect ball. First time, but he hasn't got a fucking left foot. He's played a million times.
Hi, pretty girls. This big game. The one glasses is nice. No, they're not lady boys. Shut up. They're real women. Girl with glasses. They like the girl with glasses. Oh. Hey. Chug some Robo, dude. You look happy, Burger. Great stream. But yeah, I think my streams where I'm happier are great streams. So I just gotta ignore the hate, you know? I was just getting so much hate from fucking idiots on coming from Reddit. And like,
they will do
black shirt is my name.
If you know what I mean. They can have their leg broken too.
Is that her? She smells good. She smells good. Rise above. You gotta rise above. Rise above. You gotta rise above. You're chugging Robotism? It's just guapinessin. It doesn't. You can't Robo trip on this. This is just guapinessin. It doesn't have dextromethorphan in it, which is DXM. That's what makes you trip. It doesn't have that in it. It's just liquid guapinessin. It tastes like shit. It's fucking gross. Hello, beautiful girls. Ah, they...
Somebody did Thai.
Somebody did something in Thai.
No, someone else did.
What's your name, sir?
You just told me. You know my name. Except my name. Come on, here, Tom.
Oh, don't be rude. Robo trip, yeah, I used to take Coricin, cold and cough pills, triple C's. That's DXM.
There you go.
I didn't even know what
it is. You can type in it, yeah.
Oh, the money. Let me show you.
Oh, yeah?
You remember that?
Yes. He's going to type. It's money. That means hello.
Hey! Yes, I didn't
want to! Yeah?
Yes, yes, yes. They don't have black hair, they have, or they don't have, I mean, they have black hair, they don't have black eyes, they have brown eyes.
You wanna see you on Canada?
Yeah, I like brown eyed girls.
Hey,
Guys, be nice. Oh, there you go. Is that you? Are you East Low Lane? Are you East Low Lane? Is that you?
Sometimes.
Oh, okay. Creep by Nick. Say that. Farong Ting Tong Mak Mak. What's Farong? Farong Ting Tong Mak Mak.
My sister.
What's this
not
mean?
Not me, my sister.
Farong Ting Tong Mak Mak. What's that mean?
Friend Ting Tong Mak Mak.
What's that mean?
Where your friend? You have friend a long time.
My friend is crazy?
Yeah.
He's coming on now.
Of course.
Yeah? I remember I have a lot of customers sit outside, so yeah.
He comes on
yes.
Pretty fun, right?
But he's like what condor is talking to
you. Yeah? Thank you for remember.
Now they're typing things in Thai.
That is
what does that mean?
That is not me. My sister.
What do they say? I can't see what that means. What does that mean?
Say that. Show him what I do.
One small man.
What?
Small man.
Small Peters?
I don't know if it's one only small man.
I'm too shy. I'm really shy. I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh, we all know that Mexican Andy only has more viewers with me because he's with Ice Beside Me.
Wow. No, it's not her. It's a twin sister.
You have a twin?
Yeah.
My twin.
Twin sister. Oh, fucking
are you serious or is that you? Is it really her or not? It's oh, yeah? Really? My twin.
They
work here. They're like, they're waitresses. I don't know why they have waitresses.
I can't live on both.
I think they're just paid to be like chicks to hang out with dudes here. I mean, I don't know. Kind of slow for a Saturday. Weird. Fat DSLs, oh my god.
What the hell's in fat here?
I don't know, I think they get paid to drink. I don't know what they do. They get paid to drink.
Christmas uniform again?
I think something changed.
Really?
Yeah. I want to share something. Nothing.
Have a good night.
Maybe.
Oh, you got braces?
Maybe so.
I used to have braces.
That was last year.
It's so good when you when they get taken off and your teeth are so nice. You're like, so familiar.
I had to think about what I read in Kismet.
Try nothing.
Try.
Jesus, this is a sad burger. Is it sad or is it sad that you well, think it's so sad and you're still watching?
Show me to
I don't know. I'm having fun. I'm just sitting here drinking.
Too many, I cannot remember.
I mean, this is like one of the few places I can film in, so that's why I gotta come here. What's so sad? He's chilling in a bar talking with us. Yeah, thanks, Jake. Jake's got my back. Jake, you the homie. Peace, Capuchan. Are you smoking weed? No, it's a cigarette. How much you cost? Oh, don't be mean. Don't say something bad. Hey, I got a new subscriber, maybe. They don't even like you? Oh, well. The bar I'm going to next is where I'm going to pick up a girl. It's the bar next door. You hate me, burger? No, I don't. I don't really hate anyone. There's just some people I prefer over others. But I don't dislike you, Jake.
We need to go and get some crisps.
What? I'm gonna have one more. I wanna get Jack Daniel's double on the rocks. Yeah, yeah.
On the rocks.
On the rocks, please. Yes. Sure, yeah. Next bar has mentally challenged girls. I thought your mom was off work on Saturdays. Oh, well, I guess you gotta pick up some extra shifts. Well, that's good. For the holidays, you know. It's good. I was trying to give her a tip, and I felt so sorry for her. And her, you know, mentally. Ouch. Roasted wrecked. Damn. Burger your mom should have swallowed. She did, but with her pussy. to catch a burger file. This show is called To Catch a Predator. That's probably my main comeback usually when someone says that. I just talk about their mom. Pretty simple. Yeah, siblings. Yeah, I have one brother named Jonathan. He's 6 years younger than me.
After 7, I should
get one for free. After 7.
When you have 10 years old, give you
6,000 sperm, and this guy was the fastest? Oh, that's a good one.
Yeah, you're always a winner because you were the fastest sperm. There you go. I'm one of the 77 likes. How many dislikes do we have, though? How many dislikes? Cringe, man.
Darling. 256. Oh, twice as many. Fuck. That's a lot of engagement for my channel, though. That's pretty good. 257 now. Oh, you added another one? Damn it. 259? Oh, it's going up now. Fuck you. Oh, the likes are going down. Oh, no. People are changing them to dislikes. You dicks. Why do
Why don't you guys want to help me out? You watch the show. Likes are better than dislikes. Eddie Bravo? I knew Johnny Bravo was. Tell us more about my knee surgery. Well, it was New Year's Eve, probably 10, 15 years ago. No, it was about 10 years ago. And my kneecap, I slid on some ice in a restaurant. My knee popped out and it chipped a bone off of my kneecap. I had to get surgery. And then I went to Puerto Rico with Viacom. But I worked for MTV. And then I, for a week, and then I came back and got knee surgery. But I met like everybody from Viacom. Viacom owned CBS, CMT, VHS, MTV, Comedy Central, Paramount Pictures, Spike TV. They owned some other channels probably too, I don't know. Nickelodeon. But I met like all the heads of programming from those. I met the vice president of Viacom. I should have like networked and got that dude's connect, got that guy's info. So like, they really liked me. But the people I used to work with at MTV, right now they're producing stuff with Snoop Dogg and Martha Stewart, my friend Paul Ricci. Well, I don't know if he's like a close friend, but like I used to work with him. He was the guy that hired me. Ross, what was the guy's name? Ross something. He was the head of programming of MTVU. MTV has a bunch of channels. MTV Vi, MTV Jams, MTV One, MTV, MTV Two, MTVU, MTV. I don't know. They got a ton of MTV channels on satellite stuff. When did I leave MTV? Well, they phased me out. I guess the last video shoot I was on, I was too hard to work with, and the producer complained or something that was working on the shoot, the like freelance producer, and they actually went and refilmed the thing because they didn't want it to be funny, but still tried to do funny stuff, and then I don't know, they just kind of phased me out. They got some hot chick.
What? All night.
You have an ego problem. Hey, Mira, let me make it real easy for you. You're banned, okay? Don't come back. Just get out of here. I don't like your attitude. I don't need to hear that shit. I thought you liked me. Be humble. All right, you're timed out. How about you stop being a bitch? Timed out for 2 minutes now, Mara. Maybe you'll think twice before you talk shit. You must have an ego too if you think you can talk to me like that. It's not my problem. It's not an ego, it's called confidence. Maybe some of you lack it. Maybe some of you could use a little more confidence. Yeah, I am a little cocky because I believe in myself. And, I don't know, I'm proud of myself. I've achieved a lot in my life. You call it ego, I call it confidence. You call it a weakness, I call it a strength. Do I resent Chris Gethard? Oh, how'd you know I know Chris Gethard? Yeah, I know him from New York. No, I don't really resent Chris Gethard. Gethard Show? Is it doing well on, what is he on, True TV or IFC? I don't know, I've never watched the show. I know Shannon O'Neill's on that show, and never really been a big fan of her improv and stuff. She always kind of does the same stuff like, hey bro, I'm from New Jersey, I'm a Jersey guy. She always kind of does the same things. She was like that
head of, what was she, like, the theater director at, like, UCB for a while. It was so much better whenever, like, Will Hines was the director, man. He was, like, way better. Will Hines is great. He's brilliant.
Oh, she's giving you the list.
Will Hines is amazing. For some reason, everybody, Shannon, I don't know, I'm just not a big fan of her comedy. It's just, I don't find her funny. Gregor Planet? Bro, if you're gonna, like, try to roast me, at least spell it correctly, you dumb fuck. 4-year-old lives in a van, 36, and live in a 4-star hotel. Soon to live with my parents, thank you. Sad, went to Thailand to get laid. I mean, I don't know, I guess. I love Asian chicks, so if you want to meet the most Asian chicks you can, maybe go to Thailand. Your coincidence is working against you. It's confidence. You don't even know how to spell colon-fidence. You like Murph and Chris? Yeah, I don't know. Well, I don't watch Murph. Yeah, I know Murph. I know Murph, too, from New York. I know all those guys. I used to do UCB stuff in 2007. So, yeah, I know Murph. I know Chris. I know, like, all those people. I know fucking Human Fish, Dave, whatever his name is. That guy, I remember him when he was, like, sucked ass at improv. And he just stuck with it long enough that he got on the Herald team. And then he got on the, was on the Chris Gethard show, and Chris was on Public Access TV. And they just, I don't know, it was a weird show. They just had, like, so many fucking people on the show. I mean, I don't know. It's crazy to me that it's so successful. But Chris was really, his best strengths are his storytelling, I think. Chris was really good at storytelling. He had a failed pilot for a show way before this other show got picked up. He's tried to get shows picked up for a while, and his other show didn't get picked up. I think it was going to be, I forget who it was going to be with, but it didn't get picked up. Then this other show did get picked up. Yeah, I know all those guys. They know me.
You made me a model. You made me.
They know me, bro. Burger, you are bitter because you've been sucking up to people who shit on you all the time. You need to do your own thing. You know what? That's good advice. Thank you. Do you have any projects coming up? Not really. I'm just trying to figure out what I want to do. I'm trying to figure out where I want to live. Who I want to... I don't know. I have ideas for scripts. I need someone to help me write it because I'm too unmotivated to do it by myself. I need to, like, have someone else write with me so they can, like, be the ghostwriter, and I'll tell them, like, stories and stuff, and we can collab. So Ball, Carol Burnett, Betty White, Tina Fey, Amy Poehler, Kristen Wiig, name it. Yeah, it's some great comedians. Yeah, good call, Jay. You know some comedy, female comedy legends. Roseanne is great too. Roseanne was pretty, she was pretty edgy for her time, for sure. She was like Sarah Silverman and what was the other chick? Sarah Schumer. Before they, she helped pave the way for comedians like that. What's the other chick's name? Nikki, what's her name? She's on like roasts. She's on those roast shows. Her name's Nikki something. Nikki Glaser.
Thank you.
I remember being at a holiday party with at Upright Citizens Brigade, and Michael Cera was there, and that girl from Broad City was there. I don't know, what's her name? Alana something. She was there. And I talked to her a little bit, but that was way before her show. That was when she just, like, just got on a Herald team at UCB. There's a lot of comedians, so they get their, they get management, agents and stuff from Upright Citizens Brigade. Yeah, Nikki Glazer. And then Alana, is her name Alana Glazer? Or Alana something, what's her name? From Broad City.
Have you ever opened a packet of cigarettes before?
Help me out.
It's a good job you're not screwing. And how long does it take to open the condom pack?
I hate the shit that I can't remember. Alana something.
Thank you, Sean.
Yeah, it's Alana Glazer with an S. Yeah, they have the same last name almost. Yeah. Okay, so I was right. Nikki Glazer with a Z and Alana Glazer with an S. Stop talking nonsense. Hang out with people around you. We're not talking nonsense. Hello, Chevy girl. Maya Rudolph is hilarious. Hey, when I worked at Brooklyn Bowl, I got to see Maya Rudolph do this thing with the Roots, where I think her and Amy Poehler did Prince songs. It was really cool. They did like sang a bunch of Prince songs. It was fucking awesome. I think it was Amy Poehler and Maya Rudolph. And Questlove was there, you know, the Roots. They were playing with the Roots. They did all Prince songs. It was so cool. And it was really hard to get into that show, but I got in because I worked there. Can I give you a 2-minute band? Yes. There you go. Anything can happen or nothing can happen. You never know. Nice haircut, not from Bert and Ernie. Thanks, I gave myself this haircut. Thank you so much, I'm glad you like it.
We will have sip.
Sip.
Have you guys been drinking too? Can you drink too? Nice, that's fun. Huh? I'm drinking whiskey.
Come on!
Goal! I don't know what's going on.
Chelsea is just cool.
Yeah. I don't know shit about sports. I'm an art fag. I made art and music. That's what I was into.
Man City are running away with the league. Like, winning every game.
Fuck City, United. I was kidding. I know, like, there's like a rivalry even in Manchester between United and City.
There's not even a rivalry at the moment because United are playing so terrible. But like,
is there one called like Assault too or something? Or is there one called Assault?
Assault?
Is there a football team called Assault?
Arsenal. Arsenal? Salford?
I don't know.
There is.
I went to Farnborough in London recently. You from UK?
Yeah.
Yeah, I went to Farnborough and I went to UK. I went to Miller and Miller and Cross. Steakhouse was really good. Where are you from? In England.
Well, Scotland originally.
Oh, nice. I see a little red in that beard.
Yeah. Ginger.
Yeah, it sucks not having a soul, huh? But like, we can't go to heaven or hell, so that's great.
I've been getting Ginger Santa Claus.
Ginger Santa Claus?
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
Which I can only,
if you get some hot chicks and sit on your lap.
Hey, Ginger Santa Claus, which I can only assume is because I'm fat now.
Yeah, I just started a keto diet. I've already lost like 10 pounds in a couple weeks.
Well, I think the good diet is to stop drinking 10 pints a day.
Yeah, I've cut out the carbs and the sugar and sticking to whiskey and the brats and just eat like meat and vegetables and stuff like that.
Whiskey smash. You know, just look at it straight.
Yeah, it gets me more fucked up too.
I drink too much, is the problem, so.
Yeah, I hear
if I
that.
Just do just whiskey, I just drink 10 pints of whiskey.
10 pints of whiskey. Man, you're on the fucking floor at that point, bud. Yeah. 10 pints, goddamn. I want to see you drink 10 pints of whiskey. Listen to the. Do it, do it.
Not tonight.
That's not nice, Conzi. Best thing from Liverpool is the Beatles.
Yeah. It's definitely not the football team.
I'll put it on us now, so we're chatting. What's your name?
My name's Chris.
My name's Josh.
Josh?
Yeah, nice to meet you. I'm from Indiana in America. And I lived in New York and California for a while.
Yeah, I was eavesdropping.
I lived in a van, but the van was parked in Hollywood.
Eavesdropping on your
truck. Nice.
I always wondered how a live stream went.
Yeah, I make money doing this. People donate occasionally. They haven't in a while, but.
I've seen it on the other side, obviously.
Nah,
it's interesting. How it goes.
Yeah, it's fun.
So, no offense, but like, who are you? Why, you know, how are you live streaming?
Anyone can live stream.
Yeah. Not to take the piss.
I've been doing this for 3.5 years. So. And then I collaborate. I went and like met up with this guy, Ice Poseidon. He had a bunch of followers, and then it helped me get more followers.
From what I overheard, you had a few experiences.
We tried. We failed.
Didn't want to back. Maybe you're someone that I should know. I don't know.
Oh, you should know. Never forget me. Do you want a picture?
I'm alright for
$5.
I'm alright for signatures.
100 baht, best offer. Alright, 50
I'm
baht.
Right, I'm alright for
50 baht, 50 baht.
20 best baht. Offer.
20 baht, alright, sold.
This cow, 5
baht. I can 100 baht for a signature.
20 baht's like less than, like, it's like a, less than a dollar.
I'll give you you sign 100 baht and you give me it back.
So what do you do for work back home, without being too specific, I guess? What industry?
IT, service operations manager.
With the computers? I'm hacking into the mainframe. I'm in the database.
Not only me.
Oh no, they've corrupted our firewall.
Now, I assume all the viewers are in IT and they know it's just...
They're experts in everything,
no,
these guys.
No. They're in IT.
If you have a problem with your car, there's like 50 people that all of a sudden are like experts.
I'm 100% that all of these people are. They clock in and they like... Oh shit, what do I do? Alright, there's some emails. Okay. Oh, I can go home.
Yeah. Time to go. Just watch. Just sit and watch the clock take around.
And then you go home, and you think, right, tonight I'm going to do something cool. But then you play Red Dead Redemption.
Yeah,
shower.
Or I can just be on my computer for the rest of the night. And play Red Dead, which I did at work.
Maybe I'll watch Walking Dead. Maybe I'll watch that new Game of Thrones trailer. I don't know.
And then
tomorrow you're like, ah, shit, I'm a working
I spent all night watching that Game of Thrones trailer. Over and over on loop.
To try and get something. I did as well until the Avengers trailer came out, and now I'm watching.
Yeah, you're on the Avengers
trailer. And then tomorrow the Spider-Man.
You ever watch the real show or just the trailer?
No, just trailer.
All you need is the trailer. It's got all the best scenes. The
trailers, and then you get on Twitter, and then you realize how hype it is, and you're like, well.
It's overly hyped.
I like hype. I'm cool. I know things. Of course I watch it.
Yeah.
Trump 2020 and Vulcan 2021.
Timed out. Get your Trump ass out of here, buddy. You just got Trumped.
The one comment I read.
Fuck Trump.
My guy in back just stole his wallet.
That's not nice.
Fucking hell. So again, who are these guys?
I don't know who these people are. I've met some of them in real life, but mostly people I haven't met. But some people, you know, they come to the chat more and I talk to them more.
Cool.
Yeah, I think I'm kind of like get acquainted with some of them. Some of them kind of come and go.
So what? So sorry, you UCB, what, LA or New York?
Oh, I've done UCB in both places.
Okay, cool. Should have kept it on target. What do you think of the kind of controversies at the both places? And I want to put
one. Oh, which? I think New York's better. I think New York's better, like, as far as, like, the open mics and stuff, and, like, I don't know, just people in L.A., they got this kind of attitude, like, people go on stage with hats and stuff like that, they're just not very professional, like, even, well, they'll wear a hat on stage, like a fucking baseball hat or something, you know?
And that's that character?
No, that's just, like, no, you know, like, in Chicago and New York and improv, you don't wear hats and stuff, because it makes you, it's hard to imagine out a hat.
Oh,
you know, okay. If you're playing a grandma or something, you got a hat on, it's like you can't visualize, you know, it's harder,
right,
like,
right, okay, know. The hat's not nothing to do with the character. It's
yeah,
just,
it's just like
they're wearing a hat and I'm a grandma. Yeah. Like, well, you're wearing a baseball cap.
Yeah, you know, it's harder to kind of like look past the hat. You know, they wear like shirts with like, you know, pretty, like usually when we're just kind of like nondescript kind of colored or shirts, you know, that don't really have like, you know, like you don't wear graphic tees and stuff like that.
Just wear nondescript.
Yeah, because then you can be more characters.
And let your jokes tell the story.
Yeah. A lot of people too like shave their face and stuff too. A lot of characters because it's more easy to visualize, you know, of them being more characters and stuff.
Obviously, I don't know. Not in the comedy scene. Just a guy from Leeds in UK.
There's just a ton of people that have just had like people tell them that they're great all their life in LA and shit, and they just and then they're fucking terrible, you know. But yeah, they keep
going. When were you
at UCB? I was just doing a lot of open mics and stuff there, but I did the classes in New York in 2007 and then did a lot of open mics there. I just thought open mics in New York were usually better. There was one open mic in LA I found that was really good called the Long Hard Improv Jam. That was at UCB, but half of them were not that great.
I only know UCB through a few podcasts that I listen to, but
oh, what do you watch? Earwolf or something?
Yeah.
That's one of them. That one's got a.
You know Stereo Scopinos?
No, I don't know that one.
Stereos is a New York comedian. Yeah, funny guy. In LA, Maddox, and Dick Masterson. That's all I know.
Yeah, Earwolf, I think, is with Matt Besser. He was one of the original UCB guys. He trained under Del Close in Chicago. Del Close like trained like Bill Murray and Harold Ramis and a lot of comedy legends.
I hear a lot of people coming out through UCB, but I also from a guy.
Well, a lot of people came from Chicago too, from Improv Olympic, what IO Theater and Second City. But Del Close used to. He used to be a Second City. I think it was on SNL for like a couple seasons or something. Then he got fired for like being on heroin and shit. And then maybe it was SNL. No, I think it was just Second City. Then he went to IO and started IO with Sharna Halpern. And then he like trained in the Upright Citizens, the people that went on to create like Upright Citizens there, like Amy Poehler, Matt Besser, Matt Walsh.
I've heard of these guys.
Ian's last name.
Any of you guys ever heard of Asterios?
I was like really into improv.
Maybe not. He's
Scottish Englishman.
Clint, yes. Berger meets his brothers.
Why do I get all the
Nah, I think I'm good. Okay. I'm gonna get too drunk. I'm not drunk yet. Just buzz. About time to go find my midnight snack.
Somebody's not too much money.
How long you staying in Thailand?
Until Tuesday, I think.
Nice.
About a cigarette?
Yeah, but you have to return it when you're finished.
I will return it, obviously.
Yeah, in better, in the same or better condition.
Or borrow a letter?
Yeah, what else do you need? You need a hand job? What do you want?
Oh, yeah. I'm all right with hand jobs. I got two of those.
Nice. Milking a cow over here. It's called skiing.
Do you archive this link so I can go home and masturbate to myself watching, my
channel? It's called Burger Planet on YouTube. Burger Planet. Usually got Burger Planet on YouTube that comes up.
I'll subscribe to you now, I guess.
Oh, great. Got a new subscriber.
I would do if I tried to do that myself. What am I to expect from this channel? Please review your own channel.
A lot of boring streams of me sitting and drinking.
Please review your own channel and sell it to me.
Oh, I would watch this shit.
I handle
the
same, not 100.
Burger Planet.
Yeah. I keep my apples.
Usually it comes up, you just type burger.
I can't do
enough. Yeah, that's the one that I'm glad. I have another channel too, but I stream on this one for now, and then a couple weeks I'm switching to my main account.
No, I mean, now I've got this one, so I can get all this footage and show it off to my friends.
Hey, nice.
I'm a big YouTuber too.
You do YouTube? Oh, I'm going to be watching YouTube stuff.
I watch YouTube, yeah.
I can't do it.
What do you like to watch on YouTube? You watch Casey Neistat or?
I watch how to complete things on Red Dead Redemption 2.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm too shit to do it myself.
Nice.
I just want to watch it back to see how your fans bring me out.
Who
do I follow on YouTube? Captain Delusion, you watch him?
No. Who's that?
Captain Delusion? Captain Delusion.
They had the heat on? I probably just got a gust of warm air coming from the
home. Captain Delusion is a guy that does kind of, oh, this is a great video. Here's how you do it with special effects.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, cool guy, cool videos.
Like shows you how to do like video effects, like, but like cheap ones.
You know when you see the video of like, oh, I can't believe how you do it. He goes, well, this is how you do it with special effects. And Captain Delusion, pretty big YouTube.
I watch a lot of some of those things too, like little video techniques and stuff. That's cool.
Well, that's what that's basically what it is. Special effects, debunking. It's cool.
Yeah.
Who else do you watch?
My friend used to host one called Backyard Effects, and their whole goal is like how to like do like very low budget film techniques and stuff, like how to make like cheap like dollies and cheap like stuff like that, where the shots look great. They did it on like a shoestring budget. Yeah, or whatever. You got a guy sitting on a fucking office chair pushing him around or whatever. For a dolly shot, whatever. Stuff like that, they make a fucking jib out of, plywood, or some, 2x4s.
I don't know who else I watch.
I was on one where he did a cable, to put a camera on a cable thing, cable mount with, bearings on his thing. That was kind of cool. Said Captain Delusion is a great myth debunker.
Love on Chelsea!
I have a show called CX News too, but
CX News?
I used to.
I don't know. I want to name drop some people that aren't just the big ones, because they've
There's a guy in London, who's that guy that does all the weed stuff that I hung out with in London? Do you guys remember his name?
Oh, the guy that makes, like, the vocal eagles and all that sort of shit?
No. I do like, Colin Furze. I like watching him. He makes all those, like, turns, you know, like, hover around into a crate, you know, like can drive 80 miles an hour or something, you know, like, soups it up, puts a jet engine on a fucking, like, wheelchair or something. You guys like Colin Furze?
I don't know.
King of random.
Ask them, who should I follow?
Yeah, his name was Drew. Drew is Sharing.
I'll subscribe to them right now.
Drew is Sharing, yeah. Drew is cool.
$1 million. Who else do I follow?
And subscription.
$20, yeah. $10.
Shoe on head.
Two.
We all know Shoe on Head, yeah? Shoe on Head?
Shoe on Head?
You know, follow Shoe on Head?
I am Shoe on Head.
Yeah?
Can't even balance a shoe right.
Who's this guy? Burger Planet? I've never heard of him. Move on. Again, you know, I don't want to just red light media. You ever heard of that?
That sounds like a porn site. There's one red light media.
Red letter media.
Oh.
Red letter.
Oh, okay.
You've heard of red letter media.
No, I've heard, I thought you said red light media. I was like, that's a porn thing.
That's
I've
a different that. That's
yeah,
a different
I've seen red light media.
No, you're too young to understand that.
I'm not too young. 36. How are you?
34.
I'm older than you. What are you talking about? You thought you were, I was younger than you?
Too young.
You thought I was younger than you? Ah, see?
I don't know.
Keto, it's working. It's all these cigarettes, they're preserving me.
Jonathan Pye, you follow him?
Nah, I don't know.
Jonathan Pye.
I watch like Dan Mace. And I don't like Jay-Z. I don't watch too many people, right?
Jonathan Pye is a UK satirist that just takes the piss out of the media.
Not Toy.
Watch him.
You guys check him out?
Yeah, watch him.
No, don't. Watch me. Fuck that guy.
You can watch my one video on YouTube if you really want.
Tell them about it. Let's watch it right now. How long is it?
500.
Oh, okay, let's watch it.
You already scared. Oh, shit.
How do I do
this?
I
really
scared.
Yeah,
my channel.
Well, Billy, I think you misinterpreted what I meant by snack.
You need to lie, you low.
My one video, 9 years ago.
Wow. Back in the old days,
next time,
huh?
Barbecue, not play tonight,
huh? Is there no nudity or anything, right?
No.
Can't hear it.
Oh, sleepy! Oh no! Sleepy. Oh. Thank you. We love you. Love you. I love you.
Oh.
Long hello. My aunt, long hello.
Little trailer. Little sizzle thing, what is it?
You ever watch the film Law Abiding Citizen?
And I'll give Sherman.
You see the Mighty Boosh?
Law Abiding Citizen is a film. Gerard Butler kicks ass all the way through the film, and then towards the end, they decide to nerf him. So I just created a little alternate ending where he wins.
So you grew up in the UK, right? You grew up in the UK, right?
Yeah.
Did you ever see a show called, well, it's Mighty Boosh, and there's one called, well, I was going to talk about, actually, well, there's Dark Merengues, Dark Places, Dark Stories, that one's funny. I like that one.
Dark Merengues, Dark Place.
Yes. Dark Merengues, Dark Place, that one's great. And there was another one called Look Around You, that one's really funny. Like, look around you, hello, class. Today we're talking about calcium. You know? It was like a fake school show. And then I love Dead Set. There's one called Dead Set. It's only like a little mini series with 6 episodes.
You know, the,
did you see Dead Set?
The Big Brother.
Big Brother with the zombies. Yeah. That was awesome.
what was great about that was that it starred all the people that did the actual Big Brother in the
UK. Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Well, like the presenter.
Well, it's great because you're like rooting for them to get killed. You're like, wow, I can't wait till that asshole dies. Yes. Like, he just got his jugular ripped out. Yeah, fuck that guy. Yeah. Well, it's scary too because the zombies were really fast. They could like run really fast. It's like the fast zombies and like run really fast.
It was made after 28 Days Later.
Yeah.
You know, some fast zombies.
Yeah, it's not like, you know, like Walking Dead. They're like, and you're like, all right, I got time to eat a sandwich. Like, they're at least 20 feet away. I got this.
Push you out the way.
Yeah.
But like fast range and fast speed.
Yeah.
I have to
get he's got the rage.
It's good for them.
28 Days Later is great.
Sequel, not so much.
Yeah, not so much. What's that one? I like the Dawn of the Dead, the remake, where they're like in the mall, on top of the mall. That was kind of cool.
What was it, Fingrains?
Yeah, that chick has the zombie baby. Is that one? Kev is banning everyone, dude. Oh, fuck, dude. Who's Kev? How's Kev a fucking mod? Fucking Kev, dude. Kev, you piece of shit. You're fucking unmodded. Who's this fucking Kev guy? Alright. Why are you just telling me now? I don't see anybody named Kev that's a mod. What's his name? Kev who? Who's Kev? Kev's not showing up as a mod, dude. Oh, here we go. Kev B. Oh, I modded him by accident. Oh, no. Oh, that piece of shit. I was trying to ban him. I must have accidentally bonded him. Fuck, who's Kev? What a piece of shit. Find him in the chat. I'm gonna ban him.
What did you do?
I tried to ban someone and I accidentally modded them, apparently. Where's he at in the chat? I'm gonna ban him. Hey, mods, find Kev and, Alright, we got him. He's banned. Alright, we got him. How many people did he ban? He banned everyone? He got banned? Oh no, we're down like 50 viewers. Holy shit. What up, Swedes? Are you a mod? You're this mod, yeah? How many did he ban? Oh wow, that's not good. Can we unban them? Yeah, unban those people that Kev banned if you can. If you have the power to do that, I don't know. I don't know how it is. Who the fuck is Kev?
The ladies are all lining up with the bar five. Only 20.
Yeah. No. Buy
2,
get
3. Yeah. Buy 2, get 3.
Buy 4, get 3.
What?
Buy 4, get the bus as well.
Yes.
And the busser?
Free the bus.
And the busser?
No.
Oh, Phineas didn't hack into my account. I tried to ban the guy and I must have hit the wrong thing. Well, I can't take you guys to the bar with the girls if no cameras in sight.
Yeah, they're here in the old ski.
Did you guys unban the people? Were you able to unban people?
Yeah, the heck yeah, take care of them. 2 minutes,
you know. Oh, here we go. There's a little letter full for it. I need to unban the last one. I can't tell when people are banned or whatever. It doesn't like put them in order or anything. I don't know.
So I'm just trying to read so you can cut me out if you want.
How much
do you have to delete? How much troll shit do you have to
do? Just depends. I just don't like tolerate racism or homophobia, kind of hate speech stuff.
What are you streaming this on?
YouTube. Oh, yeah. Yep. It's weird, my left nostril is like more clogged up my right one.
I think it's weird. Who has the energy to.
That's why I tried to ban him, he's gonna be fat.
No, who has the energy to watch you and then just to start shit?
I don't know. There's a lot of sick people in this room.
There's a lot of bored people.
Yeah, they're bored.
I don't know if they're sick, I think they're just fucking bored.
Yeah, they just want to get attention. Their dad left, you know, he wasn't around, and they just screamed.
I think it's...
Is a little bored in here?
I think it's cool. You know, you're just bored. You know, what do? You just tease the...
Just troll.
You just tease the easy kid. You tease the kid that's... whatever, and what you do on the internet, just spout as much shit as you can. What are those guys think?
I don't know.
Ray Dead Eric's channel.
A lot of these people aren't free thinkers and just follow the crowd.
Ray Dead Eric's channel. I've got like 2 videos on there.
Of Red Dead Redemption?
No. Of that shitty thing from 9 years ago. And I don't know what else.
Are they checking it out?
I don't know. Give me some hits. I'll sign up for monetization. Who's that, Dan Harris?
He said he makes horror films in the UK.
Derek, look, Hoffman. Love you.
Now, why is it okay for you to do that to me? If I go to do that to you,
where do I come from? Where do I come from? UK!
UK!
Manchester! Manchester United!
Well, guys, I'm gonna end the stream. Guys, I'm into the stream. Have a great night. Thanks for joining me. Hope you guys have a great evening. I'll see you tomorrow. Peace, guys. Thanks for all the donations. Thanks for your love. Shout out to Vagabond. Shout outs to Jack.
Jackalogical, and everyone else who donated. And love you guys. Peace. Talk to you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye.